Thank you for tuning in to LA Talk Live, reality radio, handcrafted for your listening pleasure. This is LA Talk Live, and we're more than just talk. Stay tuned.
Wake up!
Welcome all to the Shopette. Okay, Mo, calm down. I know they can't see us right now. How about that? Hi, welcome to the Shock Factor here on LA Talk Live. Another Freaky Friday, and it's going down today, tonight, here on the Shock Factor on LATalkLive.com. We want to thank you guys for tuning in. We really appreciate you for tuning in. Always and forever, we want to thank our friends, our family that's out there tuned in. I'm the host of The Shock Factor, and my name is Shakim Williams.
And I am the co-host of The Shock Factor. I'm Chef Momo.
And she is, and she's looking fantabulous as always. Let's, ladies and gentlemen, give her a rousing round of applause.
You're being nice, y'all, because I bought food.
Thank you.
It treats me really well when I bring vittles.
Oh, my God. People are running late. Traffic outside.
Traffic is crazy.
Is a mess.
Yeah.
And we're going to go ahead and get this party started regardless. But, wow, Mo, it's just so much going on in the world.
Tell me about it.
What's been going on in your week? Right quick before we go ahead and get this, you know. Freaky Friday,
right?
By the way.
Oh, it's Freaky Friday. Woo-woo, my type of Friday.
It's Freaky Friday. We don't know what is going to happen here on Freaky Friday.
Right.
Ladies and gentlemen, get prepared for the world's largest crew here in the world.
Right. Oh, God. Yeah. All you need is a little DJ. Freaky, freaky, a little DJ spin. That's what you need. We need that. You need to get that chicken, chicken.
I got to get that.
Yeah.
Well, guess who walked in running a little? He's running 5 minutes late, ladies and gentlemen. We're going to allow him.
Right, he said, but I'm here. You made it, right?
Just come on the set.
Oh, my God. Look
in the middle, it just started just.
Look who's strolling in.
I'm here.
You know,
I'm here. I'm
I don't
here.
Know. He got. I guess he has it like that because he's our co-host. Want to welcome to, ladies and gentlemen, welcome Life MC to the panel.
And he ain't even sat down yet.
Come on, Life. Get down there, buddy.
No, but on a serious note, right, you made it.
You're right there.
On a serious note, my condolences go out to the families of the Philippines, the typhoon that hit the Philippines.
God,
and
right,
it hits kind of close to home. My best friend is Filipino, and thank God her family is safe. But they're saying they're still pulling out bodies, and it'll probably be about 100 to 150 more bodies a day that they're recovering. And it's mostly children. So, you know, my condolences. And if you can donate, if you go on my Facebook page, Monique Moy, or it might be Monique S. Moy, I can't remember. But there's a page on there where you can donate food and different items. It's a link that you can click on and donate whatever you can donate. And the game, shout out to the game, too. He's donated with the Robin Hood Project. He's donated like $10,000.
Wow. Yeah.
The Lakers donated like $150,000.
Yeah. So shout out to everybody that's stepping up to the plate.
Yeah,
and
absolutely.
It's about,
I mean,
know,
at least it's
humanity.
Something, you know.
Yeah.
Granted that they're sitting on hundreds of millions. But, hey, $100,000.
You got to start somewhere.
Yeah, you got to start somewhere, you
know.
Yeah. And so, that's for real.
That's good. But but so shout out to Lonnie. Lonnie, that's my BFF and your
family.
Hey,
Lonnie.
So love you, girl. Glad everything is kosher with your family. So
yeah. Oh, that's Lonnie's family?
Yeah, Lonnie is from the Philippines. She's from a small, tiny little like village.
Are you serious?
Yeah. Yep. Yep. So she was upset. Like she hadn't heard from her grandma and was upset, so I'm glad that her family is well. So God bless everybody in the Philippines right now.
Yeah, man, because that hurricane
typhoon.
Mm-hmm. You know, by the way, was it? They said one of the worst.
Yep.
Typhoons, and you know, we're looking at climate change that's going on. You know, a volcano. Where was that volcano that just erupted? It's just been erupting for the last 2 weeks.
Right.
And there are a lot of changes that's going on. Scientists have come out and said that the water is warming.
Mm-hmm.
You know, the earth is warming up, and a lot of people's like, nah.
Right.
You know, they're doing chemtrails. A lot of people don't understand and know what chemtrails are, but if you ever look up in the sky, ladies and gentlemen, I talk about this every now and then. But if you ever get a chance to look up in the sky, like what looks like a contrail. Condensation trail, but they're longer lines in the sky, and they form these patterns. They call those chemtrails, and what those are what they're spraying these particulates out, aluminum, barium, strontium, and they're causing what their scientists say they're doing geoengineering, and they're doing it in all NATO countries, by the way. So got to understand, just look it up, you know, do your due diligence and just look it up, and whatever you find out for yourself and what works for you and your family, do that. But nevertheless, if you can, just drink some 9.5, drink some alkaline water.
Thank God for mine.
Or the food, you know what I'm saying?
Drink
alkaline food, what Dr. Sabi said. We got to get Dr. Sabi back
on
here.
We do. We got to.
Yeah, because they eating us alive on that Dr. Sabi interview we did. they just ate us alive. Like, you know, Dr. Sabi has, you know, a crew of cats that really follow Dr. Sabi.
Right.
And he's very smart. He's very, you know, intelligent about what he does. And, you know, he's 96.
And he just had a baby.
Yeah, he's about 3 years old.
He said that's like 3 years old. And he's like, what?
So they was getting in. So Life.
What's up?
Welcome back to the Shock Factor. How you doing there, my brother?
Wonderful.
Yeah. What's going on with you, man? How was your week?
It was good. I was at the hospital yesterday. Got an announcement to make.
Go ahead. By the way.
What the hell?
By the way, this is a good announcement.
It's good because I was walking. I was with my son, my oldest one yesterday. And it was like, these are the only times I really like hospitals. My god sister had a baby.
Oh, phew, boy. Okay. You see how I'm looking at you?
Yeah. So, and my god sister is, for people Congrats. Who don't know, Sherry Truth Hurts Watson, my sis. She just had a nice bundle of joy. Prince. Harlem.
Wow. Congratulations.
Right.
And congratulations. Harlem's in town, too.
What's up with him? Is he coming?
He's not. But we might see him next week.
I can only imagine why he's not.
Right.
You because know, just newborn.
Yeah.
And just looking at the
right
baby.
There for the whole process. And it was lovely.
So we got a great show lined up tonight. We Mo has.
Let me
get you guys in. We got a very special guest that's coming in tonight, Morris Day of the Time. He's coming in
Morris
around.
Morris Hayes.
Morris Hayes.
Morris Hayes.
Morris Hayes.
Yes. I was like, not of the time. Morris Hayes.
Boy, did I mess that up.
Yeah,
tonight.
You messed that all the way up. He is.
Okay. He was in the group.
Right. Hold on, guys. Hold on. Let me just say this. I got to cut off everybody. Boy. Ladies and gentlemen, I want to apologize. Today, if you tuned in to check out Morris Day of the Time. I can't have anybody on right now. I have to do this official apology. I want to say I'm sorry. I can't have anybody on right now. I just want to apologize. If you tuned in, just go ahead and tune out. I miss Fred. Oh. So I'm gonna get everybody else back in here for one quick second, and oh my god, hold on, guys.
I didn't post them, guys.
This guy,
I
man,
did tell a couple.
Did he say the minutes?
Yeah, he gonna say Morris. We got
okay,
more.
I can't get your job back in. Hold on, I gotta cut y'all. Okay, guys, I'm bringing everybody back in one more time. First and foremost,
this
I wanna,
is LA Talk Live, and we hype shit up, huh? We lie and say we got these kind of guests, huh?
Hey, you know,
Morris Day.
Mo, I know we was talking
and
about
the getting, time.
It's so crazy about it. We've been talking about this we've all week long. Actually.
And he still said Morris Day.
No,
I got hyped.
I really thought that okay. it
and
was.
Well, Morris Day is down, downstairs. Well, so, Stu, can you do me a favor?
You might as well say it. You might as well say his cousin was going to come in. You know,
oh, yeah.
Morris Day cousin coming in today.
It's actually Morris Hayes, who is the pianist for Prince.
You see,
so it's not the time, but he does play for Prince.
He's talking about Morris Hayes or the Timers.
That's just
the Timers.
Okay. I'm glad he wasn't in the studio
man.
Right now.
He'd be like, who is that?
He'd be like, I'm walking back out.
No, he would have said,
okay, guys, look.
You know what he would have said?
Okay, hold on, guys. Wait a minute. Wait a minute, guys. Seriously, wait a minute. Let's not talk about this when the guy walk in, okay? Okay.
Let's days.
It's all a good fun. He's very
it's Morris
humble.
Days.
He likes what, to play
what
so he was
what
about
to say he plays guitar?
Piano. I
he
can't
said
even
he would have Morris Days on. With
oh, okay. So, ladies and gentlemen, we're going to take a quick break. We're going to come back with some shock factor in a minute. I can't have anybody else on right now because... This guy's going to walk in here, and they're going to keep on talking about this. And oh, God, here we go again. We're going to take a quick break. We're going to come back with more shock factor. We're going to get this whole thing wrapped up the way it's supposed to be. I apologize, ladies and gentlemen. I really do. I apologize, first and foremost, but we're going to take a quick break. And I can't have anybody else on because they're talking too much. And we'll take a quick break. Come back with more Shock Factor here on LA Talk Live. Okay? I'm sorry. Please forgive me. If you grew up with holes in your zap of toes, you celebrate the minute you was having dope. I'm like, fuck critics, you can kiss my whole asshole. If you don't like my lyrics, you can press fast forward. Got beef with radio. If I don't play they show, they don't play my hits. Well, I don't give a shit. So rap max try and use my black ass so advertisers could give them more cash for ads, fuckers. I don't know what you take me as or understand the intelligence that Jay-Z has. I'm from rags, the richest niggas, I ain't dumb. I got 99 problems, but a bitch ain't one. Hit me! 99
99 problems, but a bitch ain't one. If you having girl problems, I feel bad for you, son. I got 99 problems, but a bitch ain't one. Hit me. Yeah, it's 94 and my trunk is raw. In my rear view mirror is the motherfucking law. Got two choices, y'all. Pull over the car or bounce on the devil, put the pedal to the floor. And I ain't trying to see no highway chase with Jake. Plus I got a few dollars, I can fight the case. So I pull over to the side of the road, I heard. Son, do you know I'm stopping you for? Cause I'm young and I'm black and my hat's real low. Do I look like a mind reader, sir? I don't know. Am I under arrest or should I guess some more? Well, you was doing 55 in the 54. Lost the registration and step out of the car. You carrying a weapon on you, I know a lot of you are. I ain't stepping out of shit, all my papers legit. Well, do you mind if I look around the car a little bit? Well, my glove compartment is locked, so it's the trunk in the back. And I know my rights, so you gon' need a warrant for that. Aren't you sharp to attack? You some type of law or something, somebody important or something. I ain't passed the bar, but I know a little bit enough that you wanna legally search my shit. Well, we'll see how smart you are when the K-9 comes. I got 99 problems, but a bitch ain't one. Hit me! 99 problems, but a bitch ain't one. If you having girl problems, I feel bad for you, son. I got 99 problems, but a bitch ain't one. Hit me! 99 problems, but a bitch ain't one. If you having girl problems, I feel bad for you, son. I got 99 problems, but a bitch ain't one. Hit me! Now, once upon a time, not too long ago, a nigga like myself had a strong arm, a hoe. This is not a hoe in the sense of having a pussy, but a pussy having no goddamn sense, trying to push me. I try to ignore him, talk to the Lord, pray for him, but some fools just love to perform. You know the type, loud as a motorbike, but wouldn't bust a grape in a fruit fight. And only thing that's gonna happen is I'ma get the clapping, and he and his boys gonna be yapping to the captain. And there I go trapped in the Kit Kat again, back through the system with the riffraff again. Beans on the floor, scratching again, paparazzis with their cameras snapping them. DA try to give a nigga shaft again, half a meal for bail cause I'm African. All because the fool was harassing them, trying to play the boy like he's saccharin. But ain't none sweet, but I hold my gun. I got 99 problems, being a bitch ain't one. Hit me! 99 problems, but a bitch ain't one. If you having girl problems, I feel bad for you, son. I got 99 problems, but a bitch ain't one. Hit me! 99 problems, but a bitch ain't one. If you having girl problems, I feel bad for you, son. I got 99 problems, but a bitch ain't one. Hit me! Got 99 pounds and bitch ain't one. You crazy for this one, Rick? It's your boy.
Hey, y'all. I'm Shakim Williams, and I'm the host of The Shock Factor here on LA Talk Live. We broadcast to the world every Friday at 8 o'clock Pacific Standard Time. Live music. Live performances, we're just live. Chef Momo, Life MC, Diana, and once again, your host, Shakim Williams. So come join us every Friday here at LA Talk Live, the world-leading broadcasting internet radio station. The Shock Factor. The Shock Factor.
Join us on The Shock Factor.
Hi, this is Dawn Christie inviting you to join me every Friday, 1 p.m. Pacific, for my all-new show, The Dawn Christie Show. Join me as I discuss love, spiritual readings, your purpose, why am I born, what am I here to do. So hi, this is Dawn Christie inviting you to join me every Friday, 1 p.m. Pacific, for my all-new show, The Dawn Christie Show. Join me as I discuss love, spiritual readings, your purpose, why am I born, what am I here to do. So don't forget to tune in, The Dawn Christie Show, at 1 p.m. Pacific, exclusively on LA Talk Live. You can also catch us on iTunes Radio R&B or watch us on Ustream TV, reality radio, handcrafted for your listening pleasure. This is LA Talk Live, and we are more than just talk.
Hi, I'm Jerry Bell of the Daz Band and New Birth.
And I'm Brahima Arsalan.
Inviting you to join us every Wednesday at 2 p.m. Pacific Time for Jerry Bell's R&B Soul Classics, baby.
Join us as we play some of the greatest hits of soul and R&B and listen in to interesting discussions with the legends of the music.
So don't you forget, join us on the Jerry Bell's R&B Soul Classics. You'll love it. Exclusively on LATalkLive.com.
You can also catch us on iTunes Radio, R&B Live 365, Radio Flag, and now Stitcher Radio.
Or watch us and listen directly at LATalkLive.com, baby.
Reality radio handcrafted for your listening pleasure.
This is LA Talk Live, and we are more than just talk, baby. We are music.
The American Heart Association's Heart Walk is coming. Bring your family, bring your friends, bring your coworkers. Help yourself and those around you to live longer, healthier lives. Form a team today and walk to help the American Heart Association defeat heart disease and stroke, two of the nation's leading killers. For more information, visit heartwalk.org.
Welcome back to the Shock Factor here on LA Talk Live. I'm your host, Shakim Williams.
I am Chef Momo.
I am Life, your boy Equal the Wolf.
I see we got a lot of jokes going on tonight. Based on me, I want to just say it's my fault. Yeah. The jokes will be on me tonight.
Yes, for the rest of the night. They're always on you, actually. The jokes are always on you.
They've been on you for a couple of nights.
Don't get most started.
But I got some jokes for you suckers tonight. Come on, don't go there.
Don't go there.
I'm just saying.
Look at this face.
Right.
I see this face on Esther. But all I'm just saying is that.
Did you just call me Esther Shaba? Don't play with me. Okay. Not tonight.
So welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to the Shock Factor. I want to thank you guys for tuning in to Freaky Friday. That's what we're calling it.
What makes it freaky?
What makes it freaky is the freakiness that's going on in the house.
Yes.
Yeah, and it's going pretty slow, Rich. The All right, so
who is that ghost? That's a ghost movie. You see that ghost on the screen? You see that ghost on the screen movie? Oh my goodness!
We got a delayed reaction.
You saw that shit? I was like, wow.
The ghost of Richard Carr.
This probably is haunted.
Man, this is an old theater. You know, it's an old theater.
Well,
the Paradise Theater.
That ghost didn't hit Shaquem in the head.
There's so many ghosts in this building. It's ridiculous.
Right.
Stevie, he'd be up in here with him.
What happened? You be cooking in the rice cooker and all of a sudden it just turns to high?
Hey, right. Right.
Okay. Shout out to everybody tuned in to Shock Factor tonight. The 200 countries worldwide that are watching right now.
We love y'all for that.
Everybody.
We love y'all for that.
We got some special guests in the house tonight.
Yes, we do.
Do I need to introduce them? Because we don't want to have the wrong name. Because he's six.
I like how you.
Okay, Mo, enough is enough. Go ahead.
You keep turning me off.
Yeah, I like how you're controlling the camera. Look
at it. Yeah, I got it. It's the last time you get a meal. Anyway, Shock Factor viewers, in the house, we have a very special guest, legendary Morris Hayes.
Morris Hayes.
I thought it was Morris Day.
Tell him who it is.
Morris Days.
Oh, Morris Day, wasn't it?
Oh, Lord. That's what they said earlier.
Jerome, that's what they said earlier that I was coming in.
Hey, look, I was about to be the Jerome and do the dance.
Right, to get the mirror with him, had the mirror, show the mirror up with him.
No, seriously.
Seriously. I was about to bug you.
Right. So the mirror, Woody, you got to put, put the mirror in his face.
Get it out, everybody.
Pop his collar for him.
Get it out, everybody. Get it out.
Chili sauce.
Welcome to the Shock Factor, Morris. I apologize.
Oh, it's all good, brother.
But I do want to thank you because Prince is one of my, if not favorite, artist.
No, don't front. He is
producer.
Shock's favorite artist. Sorry, don't even front.
You know, and this Shock's is better favorite. Than Morris Day, actually,
he
for
got
me.
Got a suit in the closet, too.
You know.
Got a purple
with
suit in the
ruffles.
Closet. Big ass ruffle white shirt.
Okay, guys. So, anyway. I know this is jokes going on and stuff like that.
No, that wasn't a joke for real. I know Shock for a long time.
Yeah, he got
a
the
big
suit.
Prince fan. So when you say one of the suit, I know for sure that
he got the pants with the chaps with the ass out.
That's it.
He got those. They
musically.
Leather.
I don't have the ass out, but I did.
High heel boots.
Ironically, I did do a show in Columbus, Ohio one time. Uh-oh. Me and my band. You know, when back in, you
he
know,
said
in the 90s.
Me and my band.
I had the ruffle shirt
one
on.
One time in band camp?
I had the ruffle shirt with the ruffle cuffs and the ruffle thing prints right. and shit
did
like
you?
That.
Damn. They
and
can't tell
crazy.
You nothing, though. But did you get off? Did you get off, though?
It was a terrible night.
Oh! We're going to shout out to people
why
in Cleveland.
Did the ruffles catch on fire?
Was you in Cleveland? Was this in Cleveland?
Well, as soon as we walked out, right? No, this was in Columbus, Ohio.
Oh, Columbus, Ohio.
So as soon as we walked out, somebody was like, oh, wait.
I just want to say, if you ever got a ruffle shirt around me.
Whoever got that picture.
Whoever got the picture, Shakim at the band.
You get never. You get a reward if you send it in to latalklive.com.
I will make sure you get some Laker or Clipper tickets.
Man.
If you have
so
a
Morris.
Picture
of Shakim Williams so, with that thing.
Okay, we don't talk about me anymore. I apologize, Morris. I will turn off everybody and we can just have this conversation. But, you know, you were, you know, the pianist for Prince. At that time, do we have Prince playing right now? Let me turn that down a little bit. Sorry about that, Morris.
It's all good.
How was it? Tell us a little bit more about yourself. You know, because we can talk about Prince, you know, but we want to hear more about what you do and what you're doing right now.
Well, I mean, like you said, I spent a lot of time working with Prince. That's my duty. Of course, we all know what a phenomenal musician he is, and so for me to be able to to work with a legendary cat like that, well, you know, it's pretty great. You know, coming from a small town where I was from, and
Minneapolis.
Well, I'm from originally from Arkansas. I'm from
Texarkana.
No, I know where that is though.
I mean, I used to date a lady from Texarkana. That's how I know.
Oh, okay.
Texarkana.
They got them down there.
Woo, my goodness, they got them because she was one.
They got them down there, sir.
Woo, she was one. Trust me, she was one. Lord have mercy.
Texarkana was like the big city from where I was from.
Really?
A little small town.
Are you serious?
Very small town.
Mm-hmm. What's the name of it? Let's get shouts out to it.
It's Jefferson. Mm-hmm. It's called Jefferson. But what's cool about it, Prince came to my city like when I was in college, like in 1981. And, you know, my little band, we all went down. We're going to check out Prince. He come to the convention center. We're going to check him out. We're going to go down and do the thing. And, you know, and at this point, it was like Vanity 6, The Time, and Prince.
Yeah.
The, you know, that whole nine from that. So we went down, my whole little band. You know, we went down to check him out. And I remember seeing The Time get on the stage. And we were like, oh, snap. These cats are, like, dope. This is crazy. And I was, like 50 rows back. And I'm like, man, I want to play with them dudes, man. And then Prince came on, and I was like, dang, that dude's dope. I want to play with that dude. So, you know, it's crazy. I still have the ticket from that show. It's in my wallet.
Wow.
It's in my wallet. And
and you end up playing with this guy.
Yeah,
you know,
dude,
Prince is one of the first artists that, you know, he's – okay, Michael Jackson is the bomb. I mean, there's so many artists and stuff like that, whatever, but Prince is the complete artist.
Yeah,
you know what I'm saying. Writer, producer,
performer,
engineer, musician, and stuff like. He's one of the, if not baddest musicians ever
to touch the
you know,
grace
the
stage.
You know, it's funny because he's a
and
you
can
know,
play
I know,
every instrument.
Genius, I know people genius, always man. See him do things, but it's really he's really really to me underrated as a musician. I mean,
really, you think?
I'm telling you, the reason why I say it, because, you know, I'll pick up a Rolling Stone and then I'll see them talking about
right, the 100 greatest guitarists. 100
greatest guitarists. And
right, right, right.
Like, I'm like, man, number 78 eat all of their lunches, man. He'll eat all of their lunches on any given day.
No doubt.
And
no
even doubt. some of those cats will tell you, you ask Eric Clapton who's his favorite, he'll say Prince. You know what I'm saying? But yet right. they'll put Eric Clapton up. Will be like here and then Steve Vai and all these. Right, I've watched Prince play a guitar and a keyboard at the same time.
That's what I'm talking about.
Steve Vai is a badass guitarist.
He's a bad dude. But Steve Vai gave me a guitar to give to Prince. Like, hey, man.
Oh, you gotta be kidding me.
Did you not? This dude was recording at Prince Studio.
Me?
He gave me a guitar to give to Prince. Like, hey, man, you know, I'm a big Prince fan, dude. And, I want him to have this 7-string guitar that I have here. And I remember I gave it to Prince and I said, hey, man, Steve Vai wanted you to have this guitar. And he looked at it and said, what is this? This guitar he gave you, I said, it's a 7-string. He said, I can do what I need to do in 6.
according to Charlie Murphy, he got a hell of a crossover,
Is that true?
He hooked in high school. Roger Nelson.
Hey, let me tell you something. This dude got handles on
him. He hooked in high school. I seen him with the big afro on the team picture.
He's crazy. I'm telling you, a little bit taller, he would have been NBA.
Right, I was just listening to, what's the little short guy? Comedian. Kevin Hart. And somebody talk about Prince. And they said that when they looked in Prince's eyes, he has those pearl eyes. said he felt it. No, him and Jamie Foxx.
Right.
It was Jamie Foxx and he was on Power 105 Club. And they was talking about him and Envy. Was talking about Prince and like, you know, he's the most beautiful man in the world. You know what I'm saying?
Right,
because
right.
How you know, so your first because he's a perfectionist.
Right, right.
Yeah.
How was it working in that environment?
For me, it was particularly difficult because I don't read music. So his musicians, it was a funny thing. I remember I would open up for him when I first went on the first tour. I was music director for, and I know this is going to sound crazy, but Carmen Electra. She went on
That's
tour.
Not crazy. That's good. Right. She was getting that cheese.
That's
but,
in the
but,
game.
But what I'm saying is, though, a lot of people don't know she had even had an album.
Yeah, I remember. Right.
I remember she did. Okay. I remember.
Yeah, she had
I can't
album,
tell you one song.
Right.
But I remember her working on the album. Right. Dropping it away.
So we were the opening group, you know, and it was crazy because, you know, he got to know me during that whole thing, and then you know, she would tell me like, "Yeah, he's digging you, man. You're gonna be in this band." And then Maite would tell me like, "Yeah, he's, you know." I'm like, "Get out of here, you know." But they like, "No, I'm telling you, he's feeling you, man. You're doing some good work and blah blah blah." And so, by the time that we got toward the end of the tour, you know, he and I had got to be kind of cool over the course.
New Power Generation.
Yeah, I was. This is when he was doing the Cymbal record right after Diamonds and Pearls. Okay. So we were like touring on that, and we were opening for that whole
That's
thing.
He was going
so,
through that crazy shit with the labels, and when he changed to that Cymbal and all that. Huh?
Well, that was at the very beginning of that. You know, the Cymbal record when he really embraced the Cymbal. That's when that album. Dropped. And what's funny about Prince, though, what's crazy is that record was done. I mean, he was on the Diamonds and Pearls tour, but that album was done. It had a piano that said, "Damn you" on the side of it. Everybody was like, "What's this?
What's this?
It was already on the next record." You know what I'm saying?
Wow.
So it was like he was already had the movie. He showed me the movie to the. I was like, "What? This is a movie for the next record."
Under the Chain Mall?
No. He has a movie that was for that album.
Yeah, it was
that
kind of
that I don't think ever came out.
Right.
But he had the whole nine. It was like I was like, "Dude, you got a movie and the record is all. We on one tour, but the next tour you already on right now.
He's ready.
So it's crazy, like." That.
He already ahead of his time.
But like, what was crazy for me is that, you know, he always has the best musicians, man, and I always felt like dang, dude, I'm way over my head here. I mean, you know, it's way over my head.
So when I was,
it was meant for you, though. It was a blessing to you.
Yeah, absolutely.
When I was talking to Dr. Fink,
yeah,
right, and, you know, he's still out. I think he's still out in Minneapolis.
Yeah, he is.
Or something like I was talking to Doc, and he was, like, talking about his relationship with Prince,
uh-huh.
Right, and, you know, how it became estranged. You know, because, you know, a lot of his musicians, you know, if you're not cutting, I don't know if you're not cutting the mustard or if he gets tired of you or something like that, he's like discarded. Like, okay, I'm to the next shit.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Right. You know, he had the, you know, Revolution, New Gotcha. Power Generation, and then, you know, he went from another band. Then he had this album maybe 5 years ago when he, the Education.
Oh, yeah, Musicology.
Musicology.
Right.
The whole new band.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? And then I think he went back, what, to the New Power Generation or something?
Well, but it's pretty much always been that. It's just been different incarnations of that entity.
That's a deep, like, so you was down there, Plaisy Park, doing the damn thing.
Yeah, I mean, but, you know, I think that when you talk about a lot of the musicians that came through.
That's dope, huh?
That's when incredible. You talk about a lot of the cats that came through, I think the if I had to pinpoint the biggest issue that I always saw with them is that they, as much as they were around Prince, I don't know if they really got to understand the cat.
Mm-hmm. Right, right, right.
Because my thing is, I just looked at the history. I just mm-hmm. looked at mm-hmm. it and saw that he always changed groups. He always changed his style. He changed his music. He changed his look. He would change. So mm-hmm. I don't know why anybody yeah. that went in the situation would be like, well, I'm going to stay forever. Or I'm going to be like this or whatever. I just understood that you go in and you operate during this era. You do your time and you do your thing. And then as he morphs into whatever the other situation is going to be, sometimes you stay, sometimes you go.
Right.
That's just mm-hmm. the way that the situation went.
I was going to ask you, was he one of those kind of deep artists where, you know, when y'all come around, did he have any, like, little idiosyncrasies where, you know, just like, I don't want this or I don't want that, you know what I mean? Or don't be around me at, you know, for 12 minutes or did he have any of those kind of little, you know,
but I mean,
take all the red M&Ms out the damn, you know, bag, you know?
No, I mean, Prince, I can tell you got along with Prince. If you came in and you handled your business, you was going to have a good time with Prince.
So he's always down to earth. So
he's just a dude about business, about music. He respects the music. He wants you to respect the music.
Right.
If you want to have a good day, mm-hmm. then come in and handle your business.
So he wasn't really mysterious coming down with, you know, purple smoke prop up. He just comes.
He ain't got nothing to say if it's all good. It's like mm-hmm. everybody's Skippy. You know, you got a problem when you're jacking up the situation.
Right,
or you're not keeping up, or you're not doing something along
you're
those
being
lines.
Cancer to this right
but,
now.
Right.
I have a question.
Yeah.
What part? It's a personal question. What part of Arkansas are you from?
It's a small town called Jefferson.
We asked that earlier.
It's like on the front of the sign, it says, "Welcome to Jefferson." On the back, it says, "Welcome to Jefferson."
That's how fast you go through it.
Well, the reason why I ask is because my mother's from Conway. And,
oh, yeah, that's nearby us. And it was cool, man. I just, like, maybe 2.5 weeks ago, man, was just inducted into the Hall of Fame in
that's
the state.
Dope, man.
Yeah, congratulations.
Yeah, it's really cool.
Yeah.
Real hand claps.
Yeah.
Yo, so which town is bigger, Conway or Jefferson? You know what I'm saying? We set tripping now.
Conway to Jefferson is like Chicago. it's a very, very small town. I mean,
Conway's
like,
bigger?
Oh, Conway's much bigger.
Represent Conway.
So I,
Tim,
you know,
Conway, look
I,
him up.
I heard the southern accent a little bit. So, you know, what are some of the songs, you know, that you know, so was it mostly, did you do any studio work?
Oh, yeah, a lot of studio work. Matter of fact, Prince and I recently, he was cool enough to allow me to, like, co-produce and put it like this. He just gave me the tracks and said, hey, do your thing.
Get out of here.
And just said, you know, and it looked like he dug it. I mean, he dug it. I mean, from what I gathered.
Because Prince is a badass.
Yeah, he don't need anything.
He's a badass pianist.
Yeah. So anytime he does anything like that, it's not because he needs you to do it. It's because he wants you to do it.
Exactly.
Right. Wow. You know what I'm saying? Because he don't need me to play keyboards. He don't need
anybody.
He can
do all of
this. He can handle it. And I mean, not only handle it, but he could get a job doing any one of those instruments that he plays. Like, if that was his only job, he could do that gig. He could play bass for a band. He could play drums for a band and just do that and still roll.
That shows that he clearly, like, gives an opportunity. Like,
oh,
that, that means something
absolutely.
To him.
Absolutely.
Exactly.
You know, what is it that you think Prince saw in you?
You know what? That's a good question because I couldn't really figure it out, but I think over time I did. What I think he saw initially is I was kind of like the MacGyver cat. I didn't have a lot of money, so the gear that I did have, I knew how to work it.
Worked it.
So I had the little two keyboards, and I remember him coming to a rehearsal, And I had some crazy stuff going on. I knew all the tricks. I mean, I had all of the stuff. I would milk everything out of the unit that I could get out of it. And he approached me and said, dude, hey, how are you getting all these fat sounds out of this keyboard, man? I need you to come, like, program for my cats, man, because this is crazy. You know, like, wow. What all you can do with just two units, you know, because these cats had walls of gear all and stuff, right. All the high-end stuff, and I had the little Rudy Poo Poo
Casio
special, you know. Right. But you know, and that's the thing I tell cats all the time, is just know your gear.
Know
your tech, and whatever you have, just maximize the use out of it. You know, if you don't have a lot of money, then you got to study the piece of equipment. And
exactly. Yeah. So I have a question. So I know you said that you couldn't read music, and so that, you know, you were kind of worried about that, seeing that the caliber of musicians that were
right.
in the band or whatever. So how were you able to be so successful not
reading?
Yeah,
my ear, huh?
Yeah, your ear.
Well, you know, it's funny. Prince doesn't read music either.
I was going to ask you that. Prince, I would say Prince probably didn't do it either.
But he has extraordinary relative pitch. relative pitch, which some people have perfect pitch, which meaning they can hear grass growing. I'm telling you, it's crazy. But Prince has this really cool relative pitch thing that he does, and he knows chords. He, you know, so he knows, you know, if you say A minor 9, he'll know what that is, and he'll play that. But what it was, I think, that was important when I came on is because Prince does everything is very fast. Everything is like very, you know, get it, hit it, quit it, get on to the next thing. Mm-hmm. And my whole thing was I just knew that I had to keep up. You know, I had that's to do this thing. And with this dude, he would, when I first started, it was crazy because he'd do some stuff. I knew he was just blowing my mind just to do it because, you know, that's the initiation of this is what you've gotten into. And then this dude was playing some stuff and he's playing keyboards and guitar at the same time. And I'm looking at this like, man, I can't do this, man. I remember saying something to him, like, to that effect, and he just said, and if this was the thing that was the catalyst for me, to, you know, from that point on, he said, you know, Morris, and then that real cool Prince, cool voice, he just said, you know, man, around here, you know, we don't really do impossible. We don't operate in that realm. So
it can be done.
He said, if you want to stay here, then we don't think in terms of
it
impossible.
It can be done.
Wow.
So we're going to figure out how to win.
Exactly.
And that was the end of it, and I knew I wanted to stay.
No option.
So he said, so whatever you need to figure out, brother, hieroglyphics, whatever you need to do to remember, do it. We can't wait. You got to get your piece so we can keep it moving. And I knew that I wanted to keep up, so I had to go put in the hours. I had to put in the time.
That's mental challenge,
and then just mentally know that if I can't read it, then I got to memorize it, and I got to do it. So that's
all right, guys.
Man.
So, look, we're going to go ahead and take a quick break. Excuse me. Come back with more Shock Factor in a minute. Wow, man, that's so dope. That's so dope. Look. Oh. You're talking about one of my favorite artists ever of all times in the world. Ever.
That's a bad dude.
I've been talking about the baddest dude. You know, and I love Michael Jackson. So look, we're going to take a quick break. Come back with more Shock Factor in a minute. And come back with more Morris. That's not Day.
Not this. Days. Not Day, baby.
Right. We'll be right back with more Shock Factor. I'm your host, Shakim Williams.
I'm Chef Momo.
I'm Life. Equal to what?
We'll see you in a minute, guys.
We know there are many choices in internet radio, and the staff and hosts of LA Talk Live would like to thank you for choosing the internet's hottest destination for the most eclectic sound and invigorating talk. This is LA Talk Live. We are more than just talk.
Tonight.
Welcome back to the Shock Factor here on LA Talk Live. That was some Prince, Thieves in the Temple, one of my favorite songs. I'm your host, Shakim Williams.
I'm Chef Momo.
I'm Life.
Oh, sorry about that. Say that one more time, Ecor.
No. You just said it.
That was Ecor the Wolf. Once again, you want to thank Ecor for being a wonderful guy. I want to thank also, I apologize, Ecor. Really.
A wonderful guy.
One, two, three, four. Oh, one, man. Two, three, four.
He's
four.
A wonderful guy.
A wonderful guy. I want to thank Morris for coming in as well.
Morris, you know, who?
It's not Day.
Not the cat. Not Morris the cat. Which Morris?
We're going to turn him off a little bit.
I was saying, please don't turn my mic off. You know, I ain't winning yet.
We're going to turn him off for a minute because he's too ambitious. Is there a mic that's close to him right quick? Let's turn that mic off. That's close. Mike, Life, I'm sorry. You're going to have to get your mic cut off too because I can still hear his voice. Morris Hayes, thank you very much for coming into the Shock Factor tonight. We really appreciate your energy because, you know, although regardless of what I posted and saying that Morris Day was going to come, this is better for me. You know, no, seriously, 100%. And I love Morris Day and I love the time
that's my dude too,
and all
man.
That stuff. And they are incredible.
Well, there's more intimate right here.
You know, but this right here is the essence of everything that I've been working for my whole life. You know, I've been, you know, Prince's my, you know. Come on, man.
Yeah, I mean, that was the dude for us, though, man. I mean, when I was, you know, doing bands in college and, you know, after I got out of school, you know, it was funny, man, because that's always what we wanted to be and what we wanted to do.
Come on, man, right?
Because our thing was, you know, it wasn't. I lived in Memphis.
I was going to say, where's undergrad?
I worked in this with this group called Fingerprint. And what's crazy is
Fingerprint,
too. Yeah. And they were crazy. These were some dope cats. I saw them play a few occasions, and I was like, oh my gosh, dude, the lead singer was crazy, the band was tight. They were like Prince band. As a matter of fact, that's how we got put on with the Prince people.
Wow, you know, man, that's just so remarkable.
That's crazy because the band was playing at a place called the New Daisy in Memphis, and Prince do it like how we do. We would go to different cities, and after we do our show, we'd do it after show, and we'd go to some club, and you know, if a band playing, if they're getting it in, then we'll go jump on stage and do a thing with them. Mm-hmm. And it was like that for this band. They came in and they actually, you know, complimented the band I was, you know, was with. And they just said, you know, you guys play the music like we do.
Right.
We usually hear people that's butchering our songs.
Right,
and
right.
Like, it's like
point.
You guys hitting it like we hit it. It sound like us. And that's how we kind of, you know, created a relationship with the bass player, Brown Mark, and, you know, some of the other guys in the group. And I eventually, you know, got to Minneapolis to work with it, and that's how I really got exposed to Prince. It was the road manager for Prince during Purple Rain was the facility director named Craig Rice, and Craig, you know, really just put me on at the studio, and I just wanted to do anything I could do at the studio just to be around the music, you know,
to
be around the situation, and I think that was in 88, Prince was shooting Graffiti Bridge.
Wow.
And I was like a PA had to walk and talk like
exactly right.
I would have did that too, man.
Put a band around.
I'd have been
right
there. I'd have been a PA.
PAs. PM.
I'd have been a PA's PA. You know what I'm saying?
I mean, I was in the movie, but I, you know, do my little part, and then I go hit my walkie talkie, be like, right. Get the family band.
Right. Let's go.
Go pick up
background. Let's go.
Pick up Tevin Campbell.
Right.
Let's go. You know, we doing the whole nine. So.
Background. Can we have y'all over here? Atmosphere.
So when and how long? I mean, when did you know that you wanted to play the piano? Like, when did you know, oh, this is my calling?
You know, it's funny because I had a scholarship in college for art.
And, what school is this, though?
This is University of Arkansas at Pine Bluff.
Okay.
So UAPB.
Oh, you went to UAPB, okay.
Yeah, yeah. So it's funny because I had a scholarship for art and did that. And then kind of like the art and the music building were in the same area. So every day going to art class, I used to have to walk by these little compartments with everybody jamming.
Right.
So I was like, oh, this is cool. You know, you look into each different door, there's like somebody getting it on the piano, somebody's playing sax, somebody's doing stuff. And eventually, I could play a little bit, you know. It was funny because I could play a little bit. I had been playing at church a little bit. But I kind of got in on that kind of, you know how it is when you got the basketball, you're not really that good, but since you got the ball, they got to let you play.
Oh, right, you make the teams even. You just make the teams even.
Yeah, you know. So
give me him. Come on, man. You just make the teams even.
These cats were, they were like, all choir and musicians that was in the, you know, doing it for real. And I just kind of was on the tip where I was like, it'd be a cool way to holler at some girls. And
right. You know, just every musician's dream.
But you know, the funny thing is we had a dope keyboard player, then he had to bow out. And then we had like this gig where Bill Clinton was running to be like the governor. And they said, well, look, dog, you got to go and learn all these songs for real. You've been fronting, so you got to learn for real and do all the parts. So I had to, like, actually wish had to, like, learn the actual songs. And and doing that, I really got a appreciation for the music. I was like, wow, well, you know, this is kind of cool. My focus kind of shift
right.
to the musical side.
Right.
Especially when we got through the gig and it was like pulled it off and it was cool. It was like, oh, wow.
I can do this.
That was cool.
You got the responses and everything. Like, yeah, I like this, yeah, huh?
One of the things that we do on the Shock Factor is because it's about bridging.
Right.
You know, the connect. You know, with artists that's new artists that's been out there and teaching these younger cats that's growing up, you know, some sense of, you know, relevance, mm-hmm. see, of not just a certain kind of or genre of music, but giving them, you know, some understanding about what's kind of going on. Because the music industry, you know, everybody know that it's changed.
Right.
It's changed. And Prince, by the way, was, if not the first artist to sell his shit online,
yeah.
And sell so many records. And he's the one who really, to me, initiated the, you know,
Well, he ushered in a lot of things that a lot of people don't even probably know that he did. I mean, if you think about it, man, Prince is a lot responsible for all the text messages everybody sent. Prince was writing, you know, C-U-2.
Right.
You know,
right,
he was
right,
doing
right.
that back shorthand. In the day, shorthand, a long time ago.
Exactly. That's,
I mean, but he's always been a vanguard when it came to stuff like that. And I mean, even during the course of when he was doing musicology, when he did the whole thing like adding a record into the ticket price. Mm-hmm. I mean, they were selling.
That was so smart.
They were
man.
Telling this dude, right. They were like, well, you can't do that.
That was so right. smart.
And he's like, sure I can. Not yeah, only sure. can I, right. that's what I am
I'm
doing.
Doing it.
And then man. They had to grandfather him into the situation because, you know, he's like, you created your own game. When you talk about people like Ticketmaster and 11, they created a game for themselves. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Prince was like, okay, cool, you made a game for you, I'll make a game for me.
Nice.
So that's what he did. You know, so he's been at the forefront of a lot of those type of things that he, you know, ushered in that a lot of cats didn't even think of. So, I mean, you got a great musician, but then you got a cat that's really not, he's just not sleeping. He's just thinking about how he can change
the game.
The next.
Well, you know Gemini's rule. So
you know.
We got to go ahead and wrap,
we're what?
Wrap
we're
this segment
we're what?
Up. Sorry about that, E-Corp.
Before we go, though, can you tell us what you're working on now?
I know
we spent like 20 minutes on Prince, so. But
oh, that's all good. That's my dude.
I mean, you know, come on.
But no, really.
But it's still
about him, though. His interaction about
him. Before he go, though, what else are you working on now?
Well, I'm a producer and a keyboard player, so what I'm personally working on.
I will be doing tracks with you.
Oh, yeah.
Just let me know now on the air.
So we're working on producing, you know, some up and coming talent, and you know, and even some people that you know, that are out in the game already. You know, we're making relationships, you know, and hopefully I'll be working with Kimber soon, different ones that's in the game that I've met over the years. So it's been good, and me and my partner, we, you know, he's starting to do film scores and things like that. So
sweet.
He just scored the movie for Slash that Slash just had out. So. We're starting to like really get involved in the film and television side of things, and so that's what we kind of got on tap. That we're going to be working with.
Wow,
there you go. So basically, man, you know, you're a genius in your own right. You know,
yes.
To be able to hang around that caliber of talent of Prince, and then to be able to play, you know, from the ear, and you know, like you said, you didn't read music, whatever, and then to still stay up with that, and then to be around a guy like that. You know, to allow you to this blessing to be there and still stuck with you the whole way through. That's dope, man. That's a genius within its own self, man.
And for the people that's watching that are trying to do music, and can you give them some words of encouragement or some advice?
Real quick. What you have to do is just respect the music. Be true to what it is you want to do. Learn your craft.
Exactly.
You know, come to understand what it is, the game you're trying to get into, whether it's music or whatever. Is, you know, the more you know about it, the better you're going to thrive at it. You know what I mean? And the cool thing about music is fun. Everybody loves music.
Everybody loves music, man.
You know?
It makes it touches
That's what it is, ladies and gentlemen. I want to thank you, Morris Hayes,
Absolutely,
for coming
brother.
In.
Thanks for having
Always,
me.
Always, no. We got to have you back because, you know, we're going to get in some more conversation. Let me cut off Ikor because Ikor got jokes right now. And it's okay, Ikor. Just take a quick break. But look, we're going to come back with more Shock Factor. We got Darlene coming up, Dunlow. And, you know, she has a great history of in this business of putting shit in. I'm talking about putting it down. I'm talking about she's been putting it down for a long time. It's one of Ikor's and family, by the way. You know, so we're going to love talking with her as well.
Oh, man, you but claim this man?
What? As they should. I'm claimed by quite a few out in this world. You dig? Ain't nobody going to be able to tell you shit wrong about
Morris,
me.
But thank you so, hey, thank you so much, brothers. My brother. And we're going to talk some more. You mind staying a little bit?
I'm good.
Okay, cool. So, ladies and gentlemen, we're going to come back with more Shock Factor. What a great... Wow, man, it's like I can't even speak on that because that was my dream job.
Oh, yeah. Hey, it's never too late, brother.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying? It's never too late.
You lived it vicariously through him. You can live your vicariously through him. Your moments of Prince.
Right, so we're going to come back with more Shock Factor here on LA Talk Live. I'm your host, Shakim Williams.
I'm Chef Momo.
I'm Life. E. Corda Wolf.
And Morris Hayes in the house. Want to thank him for stopping up.
The real Morris Hayes. You know what I'm saying? Twitter, the real Morris Hayes.
Yeah.
We're going to come back with more Shock Factor in a minute here on LA Talk Live. Freaky Friday is what we're calling it. We'll see you in a couple of minutes. We'll be back.
Choices in internet radio, and the staff and host of LA Talk Live would like to thank you for choosing the internet's hottest destination for the most eclectic sound and invigorating talk. This is LA Talk Live. We are more than just talk.
I got the dagger back. It's the Rock Bastards. We are back. And the easy Jigga Man, BC's and MEZ. Oskino and Sparks and Free Weezy. Mickey, Mallory, Chris, and Eve. All I need is the love of my crew. The whole industry can hate me. I thug my way through. And all I need is a chick to hold a jammy like Meth and Mary, like Marvin and Tammy. Now understands we can't be stopped from blowing Swiss and sweets out of candy drops. Like we underground kings riding dirty. A nigga been focused since I said hi to 30. Young niggas, y'all can't hurt me. Better watch and observe me and learn how to earn better. I burn cheddar, I set fire to your empire. I blow smoke in your face, burn rubber off of rim tires. Yes, Aya, J-Aya, double G-A, live wire, nigga, holla back. All I need, rock aware, check, night gear, check, me bucket.
Armadale in the club, couple of duckets, yeah. Couple chicks by my side, let's ride. All I need a new coupe, a do-rag in a pocket full of loot. Got those. A sunny day, some chicks they wanna play in, I'll be on my way. Come on, now. All I need in this world is sin. It's me and my girlfriend. I got a little tutu, I call her Peggy Sue. When I'm off in the club, she fit right in my shoe. Gotta switch it to my waist, just in case. A clown one flip, gotta reach for my bitch. Y'all wanna act out a movie, I could give you a clip. But no ad-libbing, nigga, stick to the script. Now all I need is a high-priced lawyer, cause it's foul ways nowadays. Everybody saw you and they coming to court too. I thought you knew, can't even steal on a nigga, motherfuckers will sue. In this time and age, what's real motherfuckers to do? When I'm surrounded by squeal motherfuckers like you. But real niggas don't fret, cause the number one crew, R to the O to the C, coming true. All I need, rock and wear, check. Night gears, check. Mean bucket, Armadale in the club, couple of duckets, yeah. Couple chicks by my side, let's ride. All I need.
Yeah.
Life in the building.
Welcome back to the Shock Factor here on LA Talk Live.
Shakim in the building.
Want to thank you guys for tuning in to the hottest broadcasting show here in the world. That's what I said, here on LA Talk Live. If you don't know, now you know. Welcome back. I'm your host, Shakim Williams.
I'm Life.
You call the wolf.
There it is. And ladies and gentlemen, I want to thank you for staying tuned in. We want to keep it always interesting as well. And we once again, we have another incredible person, you know, that's in that's blessing us with her presence. Ladies and gentlemen, I want to welcome to our panel, to our dais, we're calling it. Darlene. Dunley, come on, man. You got me messed up again, man. Okay, you said.
You on point. Go ahead. Yeah, we have the illustrious.
You do it.
Illustrious.
He said illustrious. Detroit born and bred.
Detroit.
Darlene Donlow in the building tonight.
So, okay, Darlene.
From the D.
So, Darlene, you know, Darlene has, you know, she's been a writer, reporter for over 30 years.
Wow.
You know, covering entertainment, sports,
and
politics.
I'm only 25. Figure that out.
And she looks good. She looks good. Yes. She's been traveling, you know, doing all kind of stuff, you know, covering, you know, entertainment, sports, politics, travel, cars. You know, she's appeared on the LA stage, Time, People, Ebony, Essence, Black Meeting, and Tourism. The Daily Breeze, also Los Angeles Sentinel as well. She's the Emmy as well. The Hollywood Reporter. Oh, my God.
Wow.
The LA Watch, Times, Rhythm and Business, Billboard, Grammy, CYH, BlackVoices.com, and so many more. Hold on, Darlene. I'm not done with you as yet. She's graduated from Michigan State University. And you know what I'm
Spartans,
saying?
Spartans. Okay.
You know, I give it up for the Spartans, you know, because they are in the conference. But Ohio State is kicking ass. So, let's keep it going.
Nobody's checking for that.
Come on. Y'all know about Ohio State kicking ass. They number one. They ain't lost in 2 years. Act like you know. Okay, so ladies and gentlemen, I want to welcome
like the football team. Ohio State.
Now, you know, she's been a publicist on stage, numbers of high prolific campaigns, including Michael Jackson, History World Tour, Nelson Mandela, right? Los Angeles visit, the NAACP, Image Award, the Pan African Film Festival, Moesha, Cinderella, Sinbad and Soul Music Festival, Jamaican Film and Music Festival, Black Women's Forum, and she's just, you know, oh my God, darling.
I've been busy. No wonder I'm tired.
Oh, ladies and gentlemen, let's give it up for Darlene Dunlow. Please, let's give it up for this dynamic.
That explains so much.
Let's give it up for this dynamic woman who's been out here, you know, laying, you know, the pave, you know, this ground. I'm talking about the foundations of just being out here and making a way for other people by just your journalistic, you know, paradigm.
Mm-hmm.
You know,
great word.
I love that.
And
great word. Where illustrious is.
Illustrious.
Yeah. Words being used tonight.
But, you know, the paradigm is not a big word. But I want to thank you for your spirit, your energy. And ladies and gentlemen, just give it up for her again, because this is, you know, for real, on some love. Thank you so much for coming here. So how did you become cousins with you.
That's more important than anything else. Wow. He done read your whole bio, but he didn't want to know.
Y'all,
for God's sake.
How you related to this
book? Well, our family is talented, isn't it?
Oh, my God. That's y'all right. Family is talented. Oh, let's give it up for the Rockmore.
That's right.
Davistons.
And the Davistons family. Yeah. Very close. They may be some of my family, too. I don't
Down
know.
Lowe's, the Fries.
Yeah. Nobody's related to you, Shaka. Yeah. Nobody. Yeah. But anyway.
we from Detroit, man. We don't do
that. That water that you had, that alkaline water.
Oh, you going to give me that water.
You ain't getting shit.
Okay. You wait till you go to break.
We from Detroit, man.
We got to take a quick break. I got to handle Mo right
y'all
quick.
Y'all put my foot up your ass. Play with me and mine.
No, but darling, go ahead. So what made you want to get into journalism?
You know what, to be honest, I didn't even know I wanted to get into journalism. What happened, and this is a true story. I went to McKenzie High School in Detroit. And my English teacher said, you know, you write very well. You should, you know, get on the school newspaper. And I went, no, not really. And she said, well, you know, if you're on the school newspaper, you can walk the halls without a pass. I went, I'm there.
I wanna
play
that
really
one.
That's how good. I became a journalist. Wow. I am not joking. That's how I became a journalist. And I have been making my living as a journalist ever since. So
wow. And you wrote 3 books.
Yes, I've written 3 books.
Oh my God, that's good, you know, gracious. That's an accomplishment.
Yeah.
Let's give it up for her on that.
Yeah.
Because there's not a lot of people in our community doing a lot of writing.
And I'm in the process of writing another one. And you want to know what it's about?
Just tell us about it.
I'm writing the love story I want to have.
Wow. Oh my God.
Man.
Is it hot and steamy?
Can I help you co-write?
Is it hot and steamy?
Because she definitely needs some love. I'm just saying, everybody needs love.
You see all that over there? I definitely. You see that all that over there?
I like that.
She got them lined up over there.
You want to have.
Isn't that okay?
Great life concept. Is in the building.
We said again,
life is concept. Out. Life balance is out. Right.
Life chimes in whenever life gets ready.
Life balance is out, right?
I'm going to do it every time. Every time.
I love it.
You know, my time here is minimal.
Right.
So I have to make sure that it's when impactful. I am here, it's impactful.
That the words that come out of your mouth.
Okay.
Are impactful.
Your mouth.
It's like good.
Because you understand.
You dig, your inner dig.
But anyway, let's talk about that a little bit.
Yeah.
About which one?
The inspiration for the next
But you want to hear about the love. You
the
know
concept
what I mean.
Of the that. Love.
Well, no, I'm just a true believer in, you know, putting it out there in the universe and then it will come back. So I figure if I write about it, I can bring
your
it
thoughts,
into
change your life.
Exactly. So I'm going to write the love story I want to
so
have.
So what's, you know, so in your perfect world, what's your love story? What I mean, what's
gotta
your,
buy the book.
What's
well,
your,
yeah, now you're
what's your,
to the book.
What, I mean, I'm you saying, what's your end result? What's your end result? Of your love story. It's like, you know, like, because most women have the end result of, you know, the night.
The white, red, the white,
the shining
dress,
night,
the night dress, the, yeah, wedding ring.
All of that. The night horse, the armor. White horse.
Right.
I mean, no, like, the white horse,
right.
The white picket fence.
Still, the, no. You know, the shining armor. The shiny armor.
Okay, the white Bentley. You know, I'm saying whatever.
No, no, not the horse.
Fabio.
I don't think it's Fabio.
No, you know what I will say? I met a man this past Monday, which was Veterans Day. I met this 93-year-old veteran.
Oh, my. Was it Dr. Sabin?
No.
Better watch out.
No. I met this 93-year-old, a World War II veteran, who has been, and he brought his wife with him. They've been married for 70 years.
Whoa.
But what was so interesting is, every time he talked about her, he said, this is my girl.
That's my boo right there.
I saw you talking about that in the post.
This is my girl.
Aww.
I love her so much. I was like, still? Yes.
Still, this
wow.
is my girl.
Still.
Yes. This is my, and that's what
so let me
I
ask
want.
You a question.
I want when my man is 93 and I'm 90 for him to say, this is my girl.
As a journalist.
As if y'all just, as if it just started.
Yeah.
Exactly.
Yeah.
As a journalist, why do you believe or feel from your observation that why there is not a lot of that? Like, you know, those long relations, those 50-year, 60-year relationships.
Which your mother and father had. You know what
yeah,
I'm saying?
Yeah, I think.
I witnessed her mother and father with that.
Oh, wow.
You know, rest
wow.
in peace to her father. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? Freeman wow. Down Low, that's my uncle. But
Down Low, that's a hot name.
No, Down Low. Yeah, Down Low.
It's Down Low, but Down everybody, low. You know, Since you're so close. Down low.
That's because when people used to cheat back in the day, it was really on the down low. The mistress knew her place.
Down low.
And look, the wife knew her place. Everybody knew their place.
I witnessed in my own family, you know, like true love, because I saw her father.
He loved that woman.
He loved that woman, and she loved her man. And I mean, they had a nice house. You know, there was like our family of like.
I want to go over there.
Exactly. You know what I'm saying? I couldn't live over there in a nice area over there. We want to go over there and hang out. You know, that kind of stuff. You know, basically it just goes to show you, because my uncle was also a deacon in our church as well. Okay. You know, our church started in our great grandmother's basement, Unity Baptist Church in Detroit. You know, and
that's interesting.
And they come from a whole different era of living, you know, where you know, like Andre 3000 said back in the day, you know, where grandma and grandpapa, you know, stuck together like grandma and grandpapa, you know, and they came from that era. So that was true love that I witnessed, and I can actually speak on that, you know, in my adult years now, you know, looking back at that, not really understanding it as a child, just knowing that that's uncle and auntie, they're together.
Right.
But she grew up in this love, you know what I mean, that she can actually say that she saw till death do us part.
Right. Mm-hmm.
You know,
my great grandparents had that same. They was together for at least 60 years.
Wow. Mm.
You know, my grandfather died at 92. My great grandmother died at 87, 86.
Right, right. They lived some great
lives. You know, so they, you know, he was a sharecropper, you know what I'm saying, from Alabama. So I get
it. Right,
you know, that's all I watched, because I got kicked out of Cleveland. So I had to go live with them.
I wonder why.
Because Mo was there, and she was farting.
You would never catch me in Cleveland. Just for the record, everybody knows
you won't find me in Cleveland.
Tough room.
But I'm going to be in for more than a day.
I was in Cleveland for an hour.
She was farting.
A layover. I hit a prince on their ass. A layover. Out of there. No way.
Really?
But, you know.
Especially during the winter.
She's fucking talking about Philadelphia. As if it's better.
Hey, watch your language.
Philadelphia.
We have the illustrious right here. Hey, you watch your mouth, young
that's
man.
Philly, though.
Come on, man. Really?
That's Philly, though.
Come on, really?
Come on, that's all Philly. Stuff.
Anyway, I cannot talk
about
that.
I cannot talk about Philly.
Philly is
that deal.
Anyway.
Y'all are hilarious.
But
I like the concept of
y'all are
of
hilarious.
Sorry, darling.
Hilarious.
That's his ignorant.
Back to the concept.
E-O-R-E-S.
Back to the concept. I really see that being a movie, too.
Exactly.
It sounds
The Notebook
or something like that, where it really would probably
that's
give
what it is, right?
Yeah, it'll probably give people hope about love, because a lot of people are really not rocking with love right now.
Right, exactly. Mm-hmm. It's all infatuation.
And it's okay to put out there what you want.
Hey, Mo,
exactly.
Especially when it comes to love.
Exactly.
It's okay.
Exactly.
So, as you were working, you know, being a publicist, what is one of your most interesting stories that
gotta
you
be
have?
Michael Jackson.
Have got to say.
What about Prince? You say you work with Prince. Go ahead.
No. I didn't work with Prince, but I interviewed Prince. Does everybody know who Steve Ivey is, the music writer?
Of course.
Yeah, so anyway, Prince's publicist called, and because we have been trying to get an interview with him, and you know he does very few.
Get on in here, Morris. Get on in.
Forget about, you know,
yes.
Trying to interview.
Yes.
he does very few interviews. So anyway, lo and behold, she calls and says, okay, you know, he's agreed to the interview, and it was just me and it was Steve Ivey, who is my boy. Hello, Steve. Anyway.
So we go
to, you know, this secret location.
That's what it would
be. Secret scroll. That's my boy.
So, but
right
this
now.
Is the deal. So the publicist comes out and she actually says to me, now you got to know Steve Ivey and you have to know me. And she looks at both of us and goes, now you got to understand, you can't look him in the eye.
Oh my God. What was that about?
That's what I asked you earlier. That's what I asked you earlier about those kind of idiosyncrasies,
like,
you know? Don't look at me for 30 seconds.
And you got to know Steve Ivey and you got to know me, because we both looked at each other like,
all right.
And we both went,
that's some bullshit.
Okay.
Sure.
Yeah. No, we went, okay.
That's
so you know
bullshit.
What we did as soon as you watched.
Right
in the eye. Hey, look at me.
Hey.
Look at me.
Put the biggest microphone glasses on. Magnified glasses, like.
As soon as he walked in the room,
so
we were like,
that,
so how you doing?
So when you did that.
Prince.
When you did that, what happened?
Absolutely nothing. He sat down, talked.
So that was just rah-rah from somebody, some other
fine.
Person.
He was fine.
It was
good.
It was that person who couldn't look at him in his eyes.
Right.
That person was the butthole.
Exactly. And you know, and pretty much the same thing happened with Michael Jackson. When I became the publicist for the tour.
Oh my God.
His people.
What tour was?
Oh, I'm sorry. This was the history tour. This was actually the last tour that he actually did. With his brothers. Mm. I mean, this is it. Was going to be the last one, but he never actually went out on
that
tour.
That was it.
Right. Yeah. So and I got to give a shout out. He has since passed on, but Bob Jones, who was a very big publicist at Motown, called me one day. Now we were friends, and he said, "So, you know, Michael Jackson needs a publicist for his history tour. Do you want to do it?"
Hey, don't, you better ask me that again. You better not ask me that again.
You want to make me mad?
I got things to do.
Right. Ask me twice.
I don't know if I can. I don't know if
I don't know. I gotta wash my hair.
Let me look at my schedule. Let me look at my schedule.
Like, what is this? It's Christmas, December 12th.
I have a new independent. I have a new independent artist I'm working with.
And that is literally. I said.
So you agree? Yeah. You agree?
A no brainer. Right.
You agree? You said yes.
Okay. What so happened? We get out on tour. The very first place that we go is Prague. Oh my God! If you've ever been to, I don't know if you've ever been to Prague, but it's the most gorgeous place on the. What? Anyway.
Felicissimo. Felicissimo.
So, isn't it fabulous? It is unreal. It really is unreal. If you get a chance to go to Prague, you really need to go.
What makes it so unreal? What makes it so unreal?
It's like walking into a history book.
Oh, wow. Okay.
It's like walking into a history book.
That's like feeling like when you go to D.C., you know, to a certain degree. When you go to Washington, D.C., you just see all the old monuments.
It's insane. So anyway, so his people say to me now, don't speak to Michael until he speaks to you.
Again.
Y'all got these rules I don't agree with.
Right. And I'm thinking to myself, okay. So once again, but I waited. We went to three countries I'm his publicist, and we haven't spoken to each other yet.
Wow.
Is that insane?
That's insane. Right.
So by the third country, I don't even remember where the third country was. By the third country, I was like, okay, this is bullshit. Seriously.
I need to get some information from you, man.
So we're in.
You need to start hollering at me.
So we're in a record store because, you know, he was known for going to record stores and, you know, we just hanging out. And so we're in the record store and he's walking around, he's picking out his music. And I just went, what the hell? What could happen except they send me home? Right. What?
What's the worst?
What?
Right.
So I walk up to him. I said, you know, Mr. Jackson, I thought I should introduce myself to you. I'm your publicist. My name is Darlene Domlow. And he turns and he looks at me and he goes, hey, how you doing?
That simple.
After three countries.
Three countries.
And I said to him, and so I said, you know, I'm going to be with you, you know, by your side. I thought you should know who I am since I've been standing next to you for three countries. He said, so you're going to be on the whole tour? I said, yeah.
What?
I said, after yeah, unless you know something I don't know. Yeah, right. I'm going to be with you. He said, okay.
There it is again.
There was it. So a lot of it comes from
people.
The people try to protect
him. Scary.
Because he didn't.
And I've experienced some stuff like that.
Let's talk about it. Because life, you know, he works with, you know, stars, you know, and those, you know, crowds of people that, you know, require
hierarchy,
you know, that they're handlers.
The rules. Or the totem pole.
You know, I've experienced that.
They're handlers, not the people.
Right, the
handlers. But they're handlers.
But yeah, it's the handlers. Yeah.
You know,
I believe they create that on their own.
I had
an
incident once. We was on tour with Puff. I was on tour with Puff. And at the time, I had an afro, so I was wearing braids, me and the other dancer. So we had rehearsed, but Puff wanted us to stay over at rehearsals. We had rehearsed like 15 hours that day.
Right.
So we wasn't able to get out. I wasn't, at least, because I stayed. The other dancer, he was able to. Puff wanted me to stay with the other choreographer. Next day was the show. So I wasn't able to get the hair braided, but I had the girl in Jersey ready. So his people come to me and tell me, well, nah, we don't know if it's going to be able to happen. I got a fro. I'm like, I was in rehearsal all with Puff all night, and you know this. So how is it not going to be able to happen? So the girl's at the door, at the back door, right? I go to Puff, and I tell him. He looks at me like, what?
Right.
He said, hold on, I'll be right back.
Now I don't want no damn afros on my damn stage.
He said, hold on, I'll be right back. He said, come here, 1, 2, 3, 4. Took them all into a room. Went in. He was like, no, but before that, he was like, 1, 2, 3, 4, come here. He's like, go get it. He said, go get her. 1, 2, 3, 4, come here. And went in on him. And that was it.
Keep that from.
Because what you know, and what that says is that
went in on them, and that was it.
A lot of the times, the handlers
falsifying my brand or whatever.
They want to. Well, you know, it's not only that.
It's a power trip.
It's a power thing.
Trip. Exactly.
It's a
power
you know,
exactly.
Oh, more than anything else.
That's what it is.
Ever. It's a you know somebody that you know that's working with a Michael Jackson or a Prince or whatever. They want to keep their power,
right?
Of, you know,
they want to make you look irresponsible. Like, right. Oh, nah, you were supposed to handle that. Nah, nigga, you were supposed to handle that.
And I say they want to keep you here. They don't want you to get too close to that person.
Right. That person, right?
Because then that person,
they think you want to take over something that I got going and I might have going.
Right. Exactly. They want to make you feel like that person is really not tangible.
Right.
Right. Yeah.
No. So I have a client. And they told me when I first went
you
over.
You got something to deal with this. Like you
when
got
I first went over to cook for this client, and I cannot say who the client is, but when I first go over.
No, I don't know who it is.
When I first go over to cook for this client, his people was like, okay, look, Mo. Okay, he's not going to really come in the kitchen. But if he come in the kitchen, don't say nothing to him. I was like, all right. But I'm not going to talk to anybody anyway. I'm in there cooking.
That's
I ain't thinking
y'all.
About. No problem. Fine. I'm in the kitchen. I'm doing my thing. He comes in the kitchen. I was like, okay. He hurry up and act like I'm making some biscuits or something so he don't talk to me. And he goes, how you doing, Chef Momo? I said, fine. You know, he was like, oh, man, what you make? He said, can you do me a favor? Can you make me some bacon? I said, sure. He was like, but can you put chocolate on it? I said, excuse me? He said, I'm just playing with you. We had a whole conversation in the kitchen.
Right,
I'm
right.
Like, so his people come in the kitchen. They're like, oh, my gosh, she talking to me. Didn't we say? Didn't we say? I mean, they're just
that's
confused.
Them. That's
confused.
Don't be them. Don't be the asshole scary
exactly.
People.
Exactly. And he was the nicest. Do you need anything?
They
you
need
good?
People like you around.
You got everything
Look,
you need?
They need people like you around because
yes.
They so tired of all the ass kissers and all the yes
that's
man.
That's what it is.
Yes, they want somebody that's regular.
Actually say, you know, I got to thank you for actually having a conversation with me. I'm
exactly.
Looking at him like, damn, right?
I need some regularity around me.
Exactly.
I need that.
A lot of the times, yeah. That's what it is. But, you know, with this whole world that we're in, you know, everybody want to keep their position. They want to keep their status. Mm-hmm. They want to
right.
Keep mm-hmm. All of that. You know, we're going to come back with more Darlene.
Okay.
In a
yeah,
minute.
We got to talk more about this love thing.
This love thing here on LA Talk Live. Look,
I witnessed it. You know what I mean?
We're going to come back with more Shock Factor here on LA Talk Live. Want to thank everybody for tuning in. It's Freaky Freaking
Yo,
Friday.
24th of November. Fish
yeah.
Fry.
Go ahead and say that right quick.
Yes, for all you listeners out there, we are the November 24th, Defy Global, Defy Pro Sport. We're having a launch party at the Mint, November 24th from 7 to midnight. Tickets, mm-hmm. Pre-sale tickets are $7, $12 at the door. We are also serving fish at an additional price.
There you go.
Cost.
Come get that fish.
Fish and fries.
Mo ain't cooking
bread
it, but it's going to be good.
It's going to be off the hook, ladies and gentlemen. We got some eclectic artists, live
Stu
stage
cooking.
Show.
Stu
live.
Is cooking, right?
Stu is cooking.
Stu is
exactly.
Cooking.
Chef Stu.
We're
Chef
good. We good.
You know, good. So November 24th fish. At the Mint, the Fish Fry, Global, Defy Global, Fish Fry, November 24th at the Mint.
And that's on Pico.
Pico, 6010 Pico. Right off of Crescent Heights and La Cienega.
And close to La Cienega.
Close to La Cienega.
We'll all be in the building. Chef.
Yeah, in the building.
The building.
LA Talk Live will be
yes.
In the building.
We will be in the building. So, ladies and gentlemen, we want to thank you once again. Please stay tuned. We have more coming up. We are not done. I want to thank Darlene.
I'm almost done.
Oh, my God. Yeah, we're going to, you know, before you leave, like, don't try to leave quick. I know you guys are more famous people to work with.
Hey, man.
I thank you for coming down.
Thank you for business and your presence.
Thank you for coming down.
I should have been present.
Well, I gotta be me.
Celebrity, yeah.
Ah, geez,
right. We're not worthy. We're not worthy.
Man, these two people right here got me beat by a long shot.
Okay,
so
whatever.
Like, try.
Okay, we know you're humble. So, ladies and gentlemen, we'll be back with more Shock for Dear LA Talk Live. I'm your host, Shakim Wiz.
I'm live. You call the wolf.
We'll be right back, guys. We'll be back with more Darlene Dunlop.
Got me beat by a long shot.
I don't
know.
Okay, we'll find out.
Sometimes it seems we'll touch that dream.
We'll touch that
but
dream.
Things come slow and not at all.
They come slow, yeah.
And the ones on time won't make it stop. So convinced that they might fall.
Not everybody.
Let's love ourselves.
We
We know there are many choices in internet radio, and the staff and host of LA Talk Live would like to thank you for choosing the internet's hottest destination for the most eclectic sound and invigorating talk. This is LA Talk Live. We are more than just talk.
Sisters is an organization that embodies and captivates women from all walks of life. Our membership includes 44 women that are constantly growing in the areas of personal development and community involvement. Monthly, we offer free leadership classes at McCade's Restaurant. Journey aims to inform women in the areas of heart disease and HIV and AIDS. Experience the journey now by logging into www.journeymosaicinc.com. Toll free 888-906-5519. Journey with no excuses.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to the Shock Factor.
Hey.
Here on LA Talk Live, I want to welcome everybody back. I'm the official host, Shakim Williams.
The Wolf.
I'm so sorry.
You're so sorry?
I was tweeting about the show.
That's your host, Momo. Oh, okay, there we go.
And that's Live MC. And ladies and gentlemen, welcome. We want to welcome once again Darlene Dunlow, who's looking so beautiful at the same time as well. We're going to talk about a little bit about love. On this next segment,
we are.
You like to talk about love?
No, let me just intervene real quick because we spoke earlier when I said we asked her like what was one of her most impactful artists that she dealt with or whatever, but she said actually Nelson Mandela. Nelson Mandela is the first is actually number one.
Why Nelson?
Why?
Yeah.
Duh.
He did time.
What?
A call.
Hold on, guys.
Against his will.
Okay, guys. Let Darlene answer, please.
hit him with the big words.
Paradigm.
I would want to know, because let me just throw this out here. You know, when his wife, Minnie, when he was in there, she held him down for I don't know how long. When he got out, he found out that, you know, she may have been a little... and scrupulous, you know, just a little tad bit, but protecting him. And then he threw her by the wayside. Go.
But that ain't none of my business.
Right.
But,
yeah, I want to talk. I want to hear about
you
your
said
experience
all
with
that.
Nelson.
Exactly.
I'm just saying.
Then you can get back to the scandal.
And all of that happened after.
Yeah, it did.
I dealt with him. My experience with him was when he first got out of prison. Remember when he did the, in 1990, when he did the whole tour of the U.S. Yeah. when he first got out?
Yeah, yeah.
And that's an interesting story, too. Actually, Maxine Waters, who at the time was an assemblywoman.
Shout out to Maxine Waters.
Called me. Now, I didn't know her. She calls me just like Bob Jones did with Michael Jackson. And she calls and she says, "Hi, this is Assemblywoman Maxine Waters." And I went, "Yeah, right." And I hung up on her.
Oh, no, you did.
Because I thought it was a friend of mine.
You did the right thing.
Ouch! I thought it was a friend of mine.
Don't do Maxine. She's a good friend of mine. Don't do Maxine.
I'm shocked, like, yeah,
anyway.
This is Maxine Waters. Click.
He on one.
So anyway, she called
back.
So you
like Dolores Tucker, right?
And so when she called back, she said, "No, this is really Maxine." And then I recognized the voice. And I went, "Oh God, oh God!"
Click right. again.
No, I did not click again. I did not. No. Wait, so anyway,
for real,
click.
So she says, "You know, Nelson Mandela's getting out of prison."
Really?
She said, "He's going to need a publicist when he comes to L.A. Do you want to do it?"
Wow, that's hot.
Now, I was not a publicist at the time. I was a writer. And I told her, I said, "I'm not a publicist." She said, "I know who you are."
How did she get your number?
That's what I said. I said, "Well, why are you calling me? I'm not a publicist."
Right.
She said, "I know who you are." She said, "But I called 5 people. 4 of them told me to call you."
Wow.
Nice.
Wow. Mm-hmm.
That's a player right
And
there.
I said, "Well, who are they?" She said, "That's not your concern. The four people told me to call you.
Yeah.
She said, that was enough
for
her.
I guess she said, ain't on your business.
That's what I've been like, click. Yeah. Say that again. Say it again, Maxine. Say it. What you say? Click. Can't hear you.
I'm sorry, Maxine.
Hear the downtown, Max. No, I'm just joking.
So wrong. You're just wrong on so many levels. You're just wrong.
It's clear that
you're wrong. So how was the experience?
I sat in the Biltmore Hotel, just me and Nelson Mandela having a conversation.
What was intriguing? What conversation that you had, that you had with him that you found most intriguing?
Did you ask him what he ate when he got out?
No, actually, I wanted to know because I thought it was amazing, and I asked him. I said,
"You got some
chicken? You mad?"
Mm-hmm.
"Are you mad?" And he said, "Why would I be mad?" He said, "That'd be a waste of time."
And he's right.
Yeah, exactly. Right.
Because, once you're in there so long, it's like, why would I be
mad? And why waste the time now that I'm out being mad?
Why would I waste my time being mad?
That's giving them even more, you know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
He said, well,
the only reason why I say what I say about many, because I believe,
it's Winnie, not Minnie.
I know, I was like, wait a minute.
I know. I wanted to say Minnie Mouse earlier. I just didn't say
Mouse.
It's
Winnie.
That's three. He's 3 for Friday.
Winnie. That's Mickey's.
That's Mickey's wife.
He's 3 for Friday.
Damn, Mandela.
Listen, we got Morris there.
Morris, help me out, Morris.
We got Morris and Doris.
Morris.
We got Morris and Doris.
I wanted to keep the M's away.
We got MDM.
The reason why I said
Morris. Yes, we see MDM, a drug. We got Morris.
The reason why
help
I said
Morris,
Minnie,
help me.
Doris, and Minnie.
The reason why I said Minnie, Winnie. The reason why I said Minnie, because that's how he treated her.
Why do you say that?
Let me just tell you.
And you don't know the background.
Hold on. Let me just tell you.
Maybe what's
let me just
what
tell
really
you. Like when he was in jail, she held down everything, and when he found out that she was allegedly involved in some shit that was involving him that she covered him up for, right? And he just dismissed her, right? Now, y'all, what was your take on the story?
I didn't even hear this story.
You didn't hear this take?
What he's talking about is while Nelson was in prison,
she
was
hadn't heard business.
She was accused of having one of the little boy, he was 13 or 14, having him killed because of some things he wasn't agreeing with her on. And because she had, at one point she had, I forgot what they were called, but there was a group of guys that were her security.
Yeah.
And apparently one of the 13 or 14 year old boys was disagreeing with the security and some other things that Winnie was doing. And he was going to, I guess, talk about it. Mm-hmm. And the scuttlebutt was that she didn't actually have him killed, but she kind of allowed it to happen.
Right.
And that's why she...
And then he left her, just dropped her. And all I'm saying
is... Well,
you can't just say
he just dropped her. He didn't just drop her that minute. Some time passed.
I mean, but he wasn't, come on. He wasn't with her. He wasn't with her. He wasn't whatever.
So you're saying.
And all I'm saying is this. And all I'm saying is this.
That she had while he was incarcerated.
She had, all I'm saying, that black woman had this brother's back.
And yes, and she all did. I'm saying, when he definitely had his back.
She 100% unequivocally had this man's back.
But do you
now? Wait a minute. Wait a minute. Now, all I'm saying is, if this black woman had this man's back while he was in jail, all that time. And all of a sudden, for some hearsay or this, that, or the third, she's just going to discard her?
Why do you say it was hearsay?
So now, is this...
That's what I'm saying.
So
like,
now,
is
he
only he knows
so
the
now,
story.
So now,
furthermore, this
is this interview
right
about...
I
don't
40
this,
years.
Is this interview about Minnie and
no,
Mandela?
No,
or is
Winnie.
It about, or, I know, I was going to say Minnie and Mandela.
But honestly,
Minnie and Mandela.
Maybe he just couldn't get over the fact that a 13-year-old boy was murdered...
Come on, man.
...in cold blood...
You come on,
because
really? We're talking about South
fact.
Africa.
We're talking about Dolly Dollar.
What I'm saying is,
thank you. Let's get back to me.
Yeah,
to Dolly
Dollar.
I don't want to. Morris.
Let's get back to Dolly Dollar.
Right.
Ain't that Morris?
Right.
That was
get back to Dolly Dollar.
No, what I'm saying is that at the end of the day, my point is that
she worked with him.
You know, and one of the, and we talked about that, but my point is that. You know, at the end of the day, he shouldn't have discarded her.
Yeah, but don't, you don't know. You
I don't know.
Really
I don't
know.
The answer.
Know
I don't know what,
man.
You could have.
She could have been. She could have been.
Over,
she could have been out there.
Years.
She could have been out there with a whole bunch of dudes.
Did you also
but
know that years. Winnie?
She could have had a bunch
Winnie
of dudes.
went to prison while he was
exactly.
in. While he was in prison, they you know came up with some crap and put her in prison and tried to break her. Mm-hmm. She was in prison for it was like over a year. It was actually it was. God, but it was much longer than a year, and they tried to break her. She would
she
not
break.
Break.
Exactly. So
she did not break.
So tell us a little bit about your stage plays, your productions that you're doing.
Oh, I'm not doing any stage productions right now. I haven't. I'm in the process of writing a book as well as a play, but it's going to be that's like further down the line, probably late 2014.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Yeah.
Nice.
Well, that's you know next year, right?
Yes. Yes, yes, yes. And you'll be hearing about it because I'm sure you're going to bring me back on so we can talk about it.
Absolutely. We have to bring you back.
So
anyway.
I want to know about the scandal of some of these people because as a publicist, your job is to make sure that your client is looking good.
Yeah.
Public eye, right?
Yeah.
So can you tell us a story where something got trumped up and you really had to...
Winnie Mandela, and
Minnie Mandela.
Minnie Mandela, that's a whole
story,
person.
That's how he treated her. He treated
person.
Her like a Minnie Mouse.
Or
anyway.
Mamie.
We're
like Mamie or Mamie.
He treated her like a slave.
This is a tough room.
I know, right? We're trying to move on. It's Free Friday.
Shakim.
Support our sister.
It's a shock factor. You see how this is a shock factor.
I'm saying.
It's a shock factor.
I don't care what she did.
Can you tell us?
Really?
Really?
Seriously?
I'm going to turn your mic off.
I'm turning my own mic off.
I'm turning
Thank
my
you.
Mic off.
I'm turning my own mic
off. Mo was getting to something.
Yeah,
go ahead,
like,
Mo.
Like,
get to it, Mo.
Thank you. Can you tell us a scandalous story or scenario where you had to really go to bat for this particular client?
There's some trumped up story on this.
Trumped up story.
For a trumped up story.
That was the word you used earlier, trumped up.
Well, yeah. I actually, the people that I've worked with, there haven't been any trumped up stories that I really had to deal with. But, you know, the thing that I tell people whenever stuff does come up is, at this point, be honest about it. Either either say nothing or be honest about it, because there's nothing wrong in saying nothing.
Right.
There isn't.
Nothing at all.
What do you think about
scandals? I teach clients to just be quiet. Because when someone's interviewing you, if you don't want to answer it,
just be quiet.
Just keep looking at them and be quiet. Because they do, especially if you're on the air, they don't want that dead air time.
Not at all. They're going to keep going. They got to keep coming.
Don't say a word.
What do you think about Scandal?
The show?
The
TV show. I love it.
Never watched it.
I absolutely love it.
I saw the end of it one night.
Do you see some of your life like that maybe? And putting out fires?
Yeah.
I saw the end of the first series, like the end of the no, I saw the last.
What's the biggest fire you put out?
The biggest fire. Well, it actually wasn't a fire to put out, but while we were on tour, I guess one of the things that happened on tour was I'm asleep. Mr. Jackson failed to let me know he was going to get married that night.
True,
he married
Debbie
Rowe while we were on the road. Oh, I'm asleep. The phone starts ringing.
How do you deal with that?
Well, first of all, the first thing I had to do was I tell the press I will get back to you. Because I didn't, they knew before I knew. I was asleep.
Mm-hmm.
Right.
So I wake up and, you know, I go to the powers that be. And I'm like, but did he by chance get married? I'm getting calls.
Right.
And they were like, oh, yeah, he married Debbie. And I went,
Was this plain?
That's like some information I probably should have known. I'm just saying.
Right. Like, duh.
Dang.
So what you do at that point is you get the information, whatever the party line is going to be.
Right.
You get the information, and that's what you give out. And, you know, they weren't trying to hide it at that point. You just say.
What they tell you?
They told me that he married Debbie Rowe. That was it. They just decided to get married. Mm. Now, why they didn't tell me to begin with was a little strange, but, you know.
Interesting.
But that, so that wasn't actually, I mean, it wasn't a fire because it wasn't bad. It was just something that I didn't know that I had to get. Yeah. Right.
How long did the marriage last?
2 days.
A couple of hours.
72 hours.
Mm-hmm. Y'all are so wrong.
42
Morris,
seconds.
Morris, help me out.
38 minutes.
43 minutes.
Morris.
Y'all not right.
Yes.
Y'all not right. But I will say this. Debbie Rowe is a very nice person.
That's why he liked
her. She was very cool. Very cool.
Do you believe that Michael Jackson, they had in vitro fertilization and all that stuff?
That he had in vitro? Or that he... That a woman had,
yeah. Or did he really sleep with her and knocked up?
He did not do that. She ain't got that to pee. I know he's like, nah.
I mean, your thoughts.
Straight.
You don't have to say.
He's like, nah, I'm straight. Going to get that surgery.
Do I think he actually had sex? Well, according to Presley, she said they did.
Blanket look like. Yeah. Blanket does look like a man.
Michael, let me tell you.
She did. She said that they actually had sex.
Michael Jackson is probably the most prolific artist from around the world.
Oh,
everybody
God.
In the
mystery,
world.
The
and I think there was a lot of false.
He's a real Willy Wonka.
About Michael Jackson.
All day long.
I think Michael Jackson
I don't think
was
he gay, none of that.
The most incredible artist of all time. So, you know, next to Prince. You know,
next to Prince?
Prince was the most incredible. All over round,
talented wise,
overall music. You know, when it came to the total package, but Michael Jackson was an incredible vocalist,
entertainer,
businessman, right? People don't know about his business acute, and he was like the most business person ever, you know, and his artistry was on point, and his you know, choreography and all like that. So I would never hate. And then he went on the stance and let everybody know that this world that we're living in and what he was going through and the people that he was dealing with were devils. And he said it, and you know what I'm saying? That's what it was, and that was the freaking truth.
I love Michael Jackson.
You know what I'm saying? He was all overseas telling the truth, and they'll never tell what he was saying over, you know, over
here. Do you know before he passed, he was getting ready to do, like, a remake of, a new version of, I forgot what song it was, but...
The We Are the World?
No, I think it was Man in the Mirror or one of those songs, but he's getting ready. But the verse that he did was so like deep that they was like, nah, you can't do that verse.
Michael Jackson wanted to do a movie, right? And he sent it to DreamWorks, you know, all those cats up there. You know, he owned all virtually, he might as well own Sony, you know what I'm saying? Because he owned the publishing and he owned everybody's stuff and stuff like that,
right?
But he went to them and said, I want to do a movie. Right, to Steven Spielberg and all those movie cats out here in California, they turned him down. Right, and then you hear Michael Jackson start talking about they don't really care about us.
Right, exactly.
Right, you hear him talking about politics. You hear him going there because he woke up and realized that they don't care about even Michael Jackson, the man, the most, one of them, if
they
not the most incredible artist ever
to touch
of
ever.
All time.
Ever.
Ever.
You know, and I, you know what I'm saying? When I'm just listening to Michael Jackson stuff and this history and, you know, his business. So you working with him is like, and then you working with Prince.
It's crazy.
It's nicely ridiculous. You know what
it's
I'm saying?
Crazy.
My two favorite next to Sam Cooke and a few other people. And I'm just saying, you know, Donny Hathaway and, you know, and Stevie Wonder.
But we were here
Aretha
with
Aretha Franklin right. And exactly. All those people. But
so can you tell us about, like, the personal side? Like, because a lot of people think one thing of Michael Jackson. I'm talking about the human side of him. They think one thing of Michael Jackson. They think one thing of Prince. Like, people think Prince is weird. People think that Mike is so... So passive.
No, Michael was
like
not passive.
Thank you.
At all.
There's no way you can
at
have
all.
That.
I heard that there's Mike was like
stern,
a real dude.
Stern. There's
yeah,
no way. Yeah. And Mike can hoop too.
Yeah.
There's no way that you can, get to that level with being soft. There's no way.
Yeah.
There's
right.
no way. You got to have some kind of
firmness.
Part
of it, let's just understand. Ooh. He was in show business.
Right. And there's no business like show business.
Yeah, he was in show business. So there was a persona that he was, you know.
Right. Meek,
yeah.
Demure.
And he was not.
He right.
In
they
person,
lying. You
he
know they
was
were lying.
Not.
Yes. Yeah.
Right.
I mean,
I don't believe he was gay, none of
and
that.
And he was, you know, everybody thought he was like, you know, he was just
flamboyant.
Eating like
I don't
eating,
he
eating,
kids.
Eating
I don't
leaves off the trees and
right.
You know, yeah. And I was in the kitchen with
fried
his cook
chicken.
Who was frying homeboy chicken.
Fried
so
chicken.
Let me just say,
look, I don't believe
I
love some fried
Mike.
Chicken.
I love it.
Michael Jackson loved fried chicken. So.
I don't believe that Mike touched kids.
I don't, know
I don't believe he touched kids and none of that. I don't believe
we know that.
That.
We know that never happened. But here's another story, ironically, that we have both of you guys here. Now, back in, I think it may have been even the 70s, the mid 70s or whatever, Michael Jackson, right, was on stage with James Brown, right? James Brown called Michael Jackson on stage, mm-hmm. right? And this is one of the first times, right? This is remarkable. Michael Jackson checking out James Brown in the audience. This is in the 70s, right? And Michael Jackson, you see Michael Jackson, you can find this on YouTube, whispering in James' ear, whatever. And James Brown said, ladies and gentlemen, is there a Prince? In the building, is there Prince?
Didn't even know who Prince was.
He didn't know Michael Jackson
introduced him to Prince.
Oh my,
that's
freaking
dope.
God!
That's and a moment.
Check this out, Michael Jackson, and James Brown showed all the love in the world. Prince took off his shirt.
They were crazy.
Lord,
Prince took
mercy.
Off his shirt. People don't even know Prince, right? This is Prince,
right.
Beginner Prince,
beginner Prince,
Prince.
Had the perm.
This is when he had the long
the afro.
Perm.
He had the afro probably.
So Michael Jackson knew this boy was bad, right? All day, every day. But James Brown didn't know who Prince was. I mean, Prince was at
he
this
was too
time.
Old. He was too old.
Right?
He wasn't mainstream
so
yet.
He called him on stage. You know, Prince did his little thing. You got to go see this shit. This is the beginning of, this is why Michael Jackson put on Prince with James Brown in this, you know, this historic place
That's
where
dope.
James was performing. So Prince got on there, whatever, yeah, did his thing.
I'm gonna YouTube that.
He got his Prince, like, you know, told somebody, give me your shit, give me your guitar, right? Prince playing the guitar, took the guitar for a minute, did a little symbol to see, and he started singing for a couple of seconds, and then he went off the stage, right? When he was going off the stage, they had these white pylons, right? These Greek pylons there, or whatever.
Right.
And he grabbed one of them and went off the stage, his bodyguard, whatever. The pylon, Prince, all that shit fell over. You know?
Wow. Monumental moment. Monumental moment.
It was monumental, but at the end of the day, a lot of people back in the day used to talk about Michael Jackson and Prince like they didn't like
each other. Exactly. Right.
And they had
the
most,
between Michael Jackson and Prince.
They had the most respect for each other and each other's craft and artistic
exactly.
ability.
They you had two different styles, first of all. People always want to compare them, whatever. They had two different styles of music, two different
but,
styles
yeah.
of Morris, entertainment.
Morris, did you want to say something about that? Because you like...
There's a few
go ahead, Morris.
Comments that are not quite historically correct. This was...
Wait, correct us.
It was the Beverly Theater gig, and that was in the early 80s. So
was it early 80s?
I think it's 83.
Okay.
I thought it was like 70 something.
No, because Prince at that time he had done quite a bit of things.
Could have been 83
prior to like Purple Rain. So it's like he's actually well known at this point.
Who? No. Hold on. Wait a minute.
Footage.
I'm talking about this is early.
I know exactly what you're talking about when James Brown had the blue suit on with the stomach.
Yeah.
the
light blue suit.
Yeah, light
he didn't have Purple
suit.
Rain.
So,
Purple Rain
wasn't. No,
it
wasn't that, no. That's what I'm saying. This is 83.
Okay.
Right
okay,
before.
I'm sorry.
Right before.
I mean, you would know more.
Listen
than
to this guy
but
right
I'm
now.
Right. Shit. Purple Rain was like 2 years after that, right?
Okay, yeah, man.
So
two
Purple
years
Rain
after
like
that.
84, 85 in
right.
that area. So, but I mean, but the bottom line is, you know, it was a
mute.
Kind of early on, definitely early in the career, but. That was pretty epic to have all three of those guys.
That was the most.
That's a, man. That's
at,
real.
At the
man.
Same spot. I mean, that was bananas.
Wow.
So
I wonder what
so
made Prince come
sure,
there. I
bananas.
Mean, like,
did you see Prince fall off the stage?
I did see the incident that you are mentioning. Right now.
I did see the incident.
No, it wasn't anything against Prince or anything like that. Because
he was just the only one. It seemed like he was just excited.
Prince
just
even
like,
so.
Then,
he,
like,
so wait, don't tell me Prince did a Miguel.
No, hey, look, nobody does a Miguel.
Nobody
pulled
that
one off.
Only he pulled that off.
Did Prince do a Miguel before Miguel like, did a Miguel.
Get the horseshoe ringer on the neck
before you go trying to jump across people. Man, you better know how to do that.
Was that what it was?
The straight horse for ring. That's a little bit close.
That was the ringer. So you were like, boom.
No, that was a prop tip it over. Oof. Miguel, Bruce Lee, the girl.
Yeah, he just decapitated. He decapitated somebody.
Yeah, blood all over the neck.
That's what he did.
That girl was,
he did not
I
quite.
I thought she was dead.
No, she had. Yeah, flashbacks about that for the rest of her life.
Right.
Stop I thought it. She was dead.
Stop it.
I swear.
Stop it.
I thought they killed her. I was in a Thai restaurant when I watched
You're
it.
You're not right.
I swear on everything that I love, I was in a Thai restaurant when I watched that. I thought she was dead.
Yeah, that was
I screamed loud. Like,
I know that hurt, dog. I know that hurt.
Oh, it had
Because it came
hurt.
Out of nowhere. And I know she was out here and all of a sudden, wow. So like what? Yeah.
I can't breathe.
Yeah, that's
speaking of that, Morris, you know,
it's a whole other thing.
It's a whole other world, man.
We have to have you back too. Yes. You're sitting here talking about one of my favorite.
He probably got like
Italy.
Got to
come back.
He got Italy stories, man.
You know, and one of the
hotel stories, the road stories.
Oh, God.
Yikes!
You know what? It's so funny. Everybody just thinks because you're in that rock and roll game, especially with Prince, they think there's all these old crazy
I don't even
stories.
Think so.
Not with Prince. I know he's more
that,
like.
That's a class A.
He was Jehovah's Witness too, right?
We didn't tear up the hotels. We didn't, you know, I we would leave hotels and people would be like, oh my God,
y'all
were amazing. I mean, they were like, dude. Because everybody have these preconceived
right,
notions.
Right, rock stars. Right.
They be telling us, like, man, y'all were, like, amazing. It wasn't all these people. It wasn't, like, we turning out the hotel. Although we'd go into a lot of spots to hear Bobby Brown just pull the ceiling down out of
right.
You know?
Of course. So now, Mike, you got something to say about that?
Yeah.
But I'm just saying.
I heard you work.
Nothing at all.
I know you're working with Bob.
We would hear about everybody else. In their episodes at the hotel, but nobody tripped on us, man.
Right.
You know, Prince y'all always was a class act.
Yeah, it was always.
And that's the reason why we wasn't wilding like that. Because
exactly,
we represented class. Him, you know what I'm saying?
You guys weren't wilding, but are there focused. Any stories where people found out where you guys were at and just like bum rushed the hotel
and
crazy and crying and fainting?
Yeah, for sure.
Yeah.
I mean, that's just one of those things.
I mean, of course.
Now, could that possibly be the MPG on your necklace right here, the new power generation?
That's what it is.
Can you show the world that, man? Let them take it all on. Put it up to the camera.
Some of the earliest shots.
So, you know, Diamonds and Pearls was the new power generation, right?
They were that's you know around that era, yeah, for sure.
Hey,
yeah.
Did you know Wendy and Lisa?
Oh yeah, man, I played with them we did the Brit Awards with Wendy and Lisa.
They're talented.
Is the water warm enough?
They're amazing.
They're out here doing. They're scoring.
Yeah, they're doing scoring. Yeah.
They're scoring
TV
stuff out here. They're doing TV
they're
stuff.
They're amazing.
They're really big.
No, that's what I heard. They hadn't
so
stopped.
They had
slowed
down.
They got into another field and just went off.
They're always solid like that.
Their team on Wendy and Lisa come together, package deal. That's dope. I didn't know they was doing scoring.
Nice.
All right, man.
Shout out to Wendy and Lisa.
This is crazy. We're talking about Mike and Prince.
And Nelson Mandela.
But
at the Shock Factor.
But think about it. We're talking about some of the biggest music icons in the history of music.
And it probably won't ever be anybody.
Prince is a living legend.
That's done. It's done.
Prince is a living legend.
There won't be anybody else like these guys.
Nobody else. And even there'll be no kid born right now that's going to be like that. You know, nobody.
But the attention span is too short. Michael Jackson's record would come out and be on the charts for two years.
Right. Now it's too fast.
We got 2 weeks.
Let's not forget about Bob Marley, too. We got to throw him in the mix as well.
I was watching some stuff on
Bob.
Before he died, his last interview.
I had the documentary, but I gave it to somebody to let them watch, and I couldn't get it back.
I never saw everything on Bob.
Love Bob.
Last thing before we go ahead, we got a performance maybe coming up in a couple of seconds. We got to hurry up and get up out of here.
Let me shout. Just shout out.
One performance. I'm sorry.
Yeah.
We got to get a performance in right quick. So, but you know, one last thing. You know, when we look at these two prolific people, you know, they, you know, everybody at this table, they inspired us. Everybody that's out there listening in some way, form, or fashion,
you've been inspired
by the two most incredible men or talent that's been on this earth.
Exactly.
You know what I'm saying? And we give much love because all the bad, you know, misinformation that they've been, you know, saying about both of them.
Mm-hmm. Right.
You know what I'm saying? Literally.
Y'all was there to do clarify stuff.
You know what I'm saying? Y'all don't know. That's, you know, haters. You know, when you hate so hard that you don't want to see your brother come up or whatever that you want to just say, you just got to say something about them. Mm-hmm. We need to let that shit go. Exactly. You know, and realize and protect.
Build them up.
We have to protect our people.
And build them up.
If we don't protect them, you know, if we don't, you know, real and relish and, you know, realize what they were in this time, you know what I'm saying?
Exactly.
Somebody else is just like blues. You don't hear black people listening to blues anymore.
We don't even know the artist's name. You know, it was made at the time.
It's gone.
So Muddy Waters. I mean, not Muddy Waters.
You know what I'm saying? We have to protect these people, you know what I'm saying, and what they gave to our society as a whole.
Yeah, man.
You know, and a lot of people out here talking this crap about this guy. Both of them. Mm-hmm. They're the most brilliant.
Prolific
artists, musicians, arrangers, businessmen that ever walked this planet, who took a stand and said, I'm not gonna keep on going with status quo.
No.
Mm-hmm. I'm gonna pave my own ground.
Right. Like you spoke about that business. I mean, what do you say?
But that's the thing. Both of these cats were geniuses. And Prince, you know, they're geniuses.
Geniuses.
And there'll never be anybody to do it like that again. And I mean, and that won't mean that it won't be something else.
That's right. Big. Right. Yeah.
It just means
not that like that.
These are some unique individuals that I just think that came to this world with
it was a great timing for them.
You know, so
at the same time, that's why
I'm glad to come from the era that I came
exactly.
from.
Exactly, it's a blessing
we're talking about you know, some iconic people, just not only in the world of music, but you know, you can be anywhere in the world and they know who these two guys are.
Exactly.
Right.
You know, and know the legacy and know what they contributed via music and then for the people.
You know what's amazing about them? That they can go anywhere and get the same reaction from people.
I think what's more, not only that, what's more important is that we as black Americans, whatever color, it doesn't really matter, but we as black Americans first, or Africans, or whatever tag or title you want to put on us, if we don't embrace them for what they were as geniuses, you know what I'm saying? We're missing it. We're going to miss it.
All day long.
We're gonna find out 30 or 40 years later, somebody else is going to be repping them, and they're going to have a different color, face, and everything. I'm just saying what the freak it is.
No doubt.
You know what I'm saying? We have to embrace our geniuses and stop acting like, They weren't all that.
Mike was like a comet that came through this earth, to this planet. A comet.
But what we tend to do is we tend to focus on the negative. That's what happens a lot of time. You know, it's a funny thing. It's just like, you know, putting black paint in a white paint bucket, it'll spread. So a lot of times,
what
happens is we have to just understand that all of us as human beings, we have shortcomings for different reasons, whatever it is. But I think we have to just pay attention to the great work that these folks have done, and the great Michael Jackson made his life of helping kids and doing things. Prince does a lot of stuff under the radar; people don't even know. Exactly.
Did you know that Michael Jackson was the most in the top person who gave money to organizations, charity organizations around? He's the number one artist in the world that's given more to so-called charity organizations and so-called relief organizations around the world. He's given over probably tens of millions of dollars that people do not even know about. He's the number one who's given out, our entertainers in the world, who's given the most money.
Right.
Michael Jackson. And they sitting there trying to say all these things because they want to, because he was out here speaking the truth. They had to stop that. You know what I'm saying? They had to shut him down. One of the most powerful, prolific, you know, artists of our time. They said, we have to stop this because you're out here speaking some truth.
And they're going to follow behind you.
And you know what I'm saying? They're going to listen to you. Just like every one of us that's out here speaking truth, they want to shut us down regardless of what color you are.
Exactly.
You know what I'm saying? We have to stand strong and, you know, and fight this battle. So once again, ladies and gentlemen, I want to thank you and thank our incredible, like, oh my God, you guys are incredible. I want to say this. Morris, Darlene, thank you so much. You guys got any shout outs right quick before we go ahead and end this segment? We're going to come back with some singing and we're going to end the shock factor. You know how we do it. you know, lifestyle.
Yeah.
Pimps.
Yeah.
Pimps. Pow. Go ahead, darling.
Well, no, well, I'm going to give a shout out to my cousin.
Peppy Le Pew. Give it up for Peppy Le Pew.
And you know I got to give a shout out to everybody in Detroit.
Oh, yes.
Everybody, the family in Detroit.
They watching.
Come
right
on now.
They watching.
Come
right
on
now.
Detroit.
They
you
watching.
Know we love Detroit.
The we love y'all. We love y'all. Look at us what we doing out here, y'all. The fam bam. Get it in. You know? That's what it's about, man.
Give it up for Defy Sports.
We done
made it. Defy Pro Sport in the building.
Right.
We done made it.
We done made it.
You know.
I'm done, Morris.
Go ahead, Morris. Yeah,
no,
thank
I just,
you.
Just much love for my people in Arkansas. Just, again, bless me with this whole Arkansas Black Hall of Fame honor.
Wow. Yeah, congratulations.
I'm grateful.
Let's all clap for that. Yeah. Congratulations.
So that's very cool.
All right.
And just much love for all the people that supported the NPG and all the music, Prince, and just you know, Black music and doing what we do. You know, we just love it.
You know, because it's, you know, once again, you know, I watch a lot of stuff, R&B music. You know, a lot of people here is on a decline and stuff like that. But we know that it's coming back.
Mm-hmm.
You know, we
it ain't never left.
Well, in the business realm, it's coming back because we're now. We have these tools that we can empower ourselves, mm-hmm. and we don't have to go out there begging exactly. anymore.
Well, not just that. I think people are yearning for love. So that's where R&B music.
No, yeah. come it's back
the,
to love.
Yeah. Love.
Like
right.
the book, like, Darlene, like Darlene's
love.
Book. Like Darlene's book.
I need exactly. love.
You better love. Preach.
That's what it is.
You better preach.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. So that's the people want to be loved. So that's why there's a resurgence of R&B music. It was sleep for a little while.
Right. And we all thank them. You know, they try to cut us out. Now, understand the business of music did everything they could to cut out R&B music. Mm-hmm. If y'all don't know, now you know. And do your own research. Don't listen to anybody that's on this, you know, panel or
Sorry,
dais.
Actually, not Shakim.
What?
No, Shakim got some good info. I got to give him that.
It's the first of the month. Shaq, yo, food stamp ass.
EBT.
It's the first of the month for your food stamp ass. I don't believe you over here talking to this craziness. No, I love her. But no, look, we're going to take a quick break.
Let me get a shout out right quick.
Go ahead.
He got to go.
So I'm going to shout out first Darlene, Morris. Great people on the show. Love having y'all. Shout out to y'all.
Yeah.
All right. Shout out to LA Talk Live. Shakim. Shout out to Mo.
Thank you, Life. Shout out to you too.
I got a text that from Jersey that Mo was looking real good tonight. So
okay.
That's for you, Mo. My people.
Shout out to Jersey.
You want
to
shout out his name?
Did you say Jersey? Shout out to Jersey.
You want
to
shout his name? You want to shout his name?
Jay Money.
Hold on. Wait a minute.
Say his name, Mo.
Jay Money.
Shout out to Jay Money.
They couldn't really see her because
her
smooth operator's forehead was shining in the light, and they blinded her for the stripper. But go ahead.
Okay, and also he got a five.
And also
got away with the five over there.
And also, like and also, like I mentioned early in the night, shout out to my god sister Sherry Truth Hurst Watson and
congratulations,
godson.
Yeah. All right.
I also got a shout out while I was speaking about my partner at Benedict College.
All right.
We Benedict. One of our classmates that was in Atlanta lost her life.
Oh.
Who was this?
2 weeks ago, her name is Sheila Stewart.
Rest in peace. She was in radio.
She was a radio personality and Radio 1 personality.
Wow.
And in Atlanta, freak accident on the way to work.
Oh my God.
On I-20, was killed. So I want to send a shout out to Sheila Stewart's family.
Sheila Stewart,
everybody at Benedict that went to Benedict College with me that knew her. She was such a beautiful soul, spirit. And you know, God's got a great one.
All right. God bless her. Rest her soul.
Shout out, shout out to them and all my people. All right.
Yeah, Life.
Thank you, Life. So, ladies and gentlemen, look. Once again, I want to thank you guys for sharing your experiences with us. It's so valuable because one of the things we do here on the Shock Factor is that we connect people that has been there, done that, with people that hasn't. You know, that haven't been there at all, mm-hmm. which is the youth that needs education, that needs teaching, that needs guidance and all that. So these conversations that we have, granted, you know, a lot of times I'd be clowning or whatever, but it's so serious because your experience means a lot. It's exactly. a wealth yeah. of, you know, of it's more than gold, you know, more than anything else, because, you know, we're growing into this new phase of this new music industry thing.
Life, but, period.
You yeah. know, and well, you know, life is a whole nother aspect, you know, too, as well. It's very important.
You guys are always welcome well. Back here at the Shock Factory.
Thank you.
Definitely
so
love
when you drop
I had
your
a ball.
Stuff,
I had a ball.
When you come, you know, when you get ready to drop your thing. Right here.
Right here. Drop it here.
Drop my thing. That sounded very personal. Right
here. Drop your thing here.
It's all a part of the love.
Wait a minute.
Wait a minute.
All
right. It's all a part of the love all you was looking love. For.
It's that essential.
I didn't drop my thing, Mo.
Only drop as much as you feel is necessary.
It's all about.
Just drop as much as you feel is necessary.
Hey, it's about that love you was talking about.
For Mo, we got to ask Mo to drop the whole thing.
You might find your perfect love tonight.
You know what? You know what? Mo ain't dropping shit by yet.
Mo be dropping it like it's on all the time. Look at
Mo
her.
Mo like dropping that conversation.
She's frisky.
I'm saying you don't drop that conversation.
Mo
is crazy.
Darlene,
this is a party.
Thank y'all for being an inspiration. Because at the end of the day, what Shock was saying, at the end of the day, y'all are inspiration.
Yes,
exactly.
And we need y'all.
Yes, thank you.
Right. And as much as you can come here and educate us, the more better for our audience and for ourselves. You know what I'm saying? On some real. Without so you know, thank you very, very much, yeah. Morris. Really,
yes, sir. Thank you, man.
You know, I don't envy a lot of people.
No doubt.
But I want to say, playing for Prince and doing all that shit, I got a knife in this bag.
I was getting ready to say, he might cut you. Hey, I was just going to go there and watch out. Because he might cut you before you leave out of here.
Hold on.
I got a knife.
Hey, dog, you want me to walk out of here right now?
Security.
I'm just going to get
you.
You
ain't about to cut my people.
Security.
You ain't about to cut my
people. I'm about to go and get him to the car.
I got
to
cut you right now, Mo.
I'm about to go and get him to the car.
I got to cut you off.
Come on.
So, ladies and gentlemen, we'll be back with more Shock Factor.
Hey, y'all be safe tonight.
Thank you, Life.
Love y'all.
For coming in. We see everybody next week. We're going to come back with a performance. It's going to be great. It's going to be awesome. So stay with us for 5 or 10 more minutes. Por favor.
Por favor. Por favor.
Thank you very much. We'll be back. I'm your host, Shakim Williams.
Chef Mama.
I'm Life.
Ecor the Wolf.
And we've just been tuned in to LA Talk Live. We just got finished talking with Darlene. And my friend Morris. It's not day, but it's
hey.
We'll be right back, guys.
As in Isaac.
Got me running through a maze like the white rat. I need a shot of Remy like Mike rap. It's like the yak is a feist that got me spilling on the right track. And I like this well, so I might get ill. On the mic, somebody might get killed. So many dead rappers, there's a cipher in heaven. My tongue is a weapon, and plus what I bust is a stuff of legend. When this Brooklyn MC come after you, you be running like I heard a caribou down Myrtle Avenue. Where we at, ain't nothing pretty, that's the attitude. To be in Fight Club, even Brad had to crack a tooth. Staring to the sun, then try to copy. Let your eyes get used to the light, because you gotta watch me. Sneak up on you like Saki. My lyrics get out of a split atoms like Hiroshima and Nagasaki.
It's the app with the app in the lab with the rap. Demonstrate how we act, we attack any track. It's the black eye piece, and we back with the facts. That with the fast skills that rose in the pack. We gotta like that, you know how the beast rocks. Entertain you, see you soon at the next spot. The crew got you bouncing and dropping your high, making eye high shakes. I'll be shocking the map. I'ma roll with the hot, I'ma flow from the soul. When you can't hold me back, kick it, keep on, keep on rolling the track. I'ma sim this simply, always attached. Give me music by Apple, the app from LA to Philippines. We're bridging the gap. We got it like that, you know we got it like that. We got it like, we got it like that, y'all.
So sweet.
It's like
that. Yeah, we got it like that.
Like
you didn't know that we had it like that.
It's like that.
Like that, like that,
it's
like that.
That.
Yeah, we got it like that.
It's like that.
Yeah, we got it like that.
It's like that.
You know we got it like that.
It's like that, cause we got it like that. That inner, it's like that inner, it's like that. At that inner, yeah. It's like a that inner, it's like that inner, it's like that. Boom, at that inner, it's like that inner, it's like that inner, it's like that. That inner, it's like that inner, it's like that inner, it's like that. It's like that. In the house, Fergie Berg's in the house.
My man fight dogs in the house. My man shot heat in the house. I sit alone in my four-cornered room, staring at candles. That shit is on. Let me drop some shit like this here. At night I can't sleep, I toss and turn. Candlesticks in the dark, visions of bodies being burned. Four walls just staring at a nigga. I'm paranoid, sleeping with my finger on the trigger. My mother's always stressing I ain't living right, but I ain't going out without a fight. See, every time my eyes close, I start sweating and blood starts coming out my nose. It's somebody watching the act, but I don't know who it is, so I'm watching my back. I can see him when I'm deep in the covers. When I awake, I don't see the motherfucker. He owns a black hat like I own, a black suit and a cane like my own. Some might say take a chill, B, but fuck that shit. There's a nigga trying to kill me. I'm popping in the clip when the wind blows. Every 20 seconds got me peeping out my window, investigating a joint for traps, taking my telephone for taps. I'm staring at the wall right on the corner. It's fucked up when your mind is playing tricks on ya. I make big money, I drive big cars, everybody know me. It's like I'm a movie star, but late at night, something ain't right. I feel I'm being tailed by the same sucker's headlights. That move that I ran off the block, or is it that nigga last week that I shot, or is it the one I beat for $5,000? Thought he had cane, but it was gold, met a flower. Reached under my seat, grab my papa for the suckers. Ain't no use to me lying, I was scared than a motherfucker. Put the left in the Popeyes and better die quick. If it's going down, let's get this shit over with. It ain't come, just like I figured. I got my hand on the motherfucking trigger. When I saw, make your ass start giggling. Three blind, crippling, crazy senior citizens. I live by the sword. I take my boys everywhere I go because I'm paranoid. I keep looking over my shoulder, peeping around corners. My mind is playing tricks on me. Day by day it's more impossible to cope. I feel like I'm the one that's doing dope. Can't keep a steady hand because I'm nervous. Every Sunday morning I'm in service, praying for forgiveness and trying to find an exit out the business. I know the Lord is looking at me, but yet and still it's hard for me to feel happy. I often drift when I drive, having fatal thoughts of suicide. Bang and get it over with, and then I'm worry free, but that's bullshit. I got a little boy to look after, and if I die, then my child will be a bastard. I had a woman down with me, but to me it seemed like she was down to get me. She helped me out in this shit, but to me she was just another bitch. Now she's back with her mother. Now I'm realizing that I love her. Now I'm feeling lonely. My mind is playing tricks on me.
This year, Halloween fell on a weekend. Me and Ghetto Boys are trick-or-treating. Robbing little kids for bags, till an old man got behind our ass. So we speeded up the pace, took a look back.
Oh my God, what was all that noise? Welcome back to the Shock Factor. Oh my God.
That's technical difficulties.
Who was that?
Mic check.
Oh, here we are. Yes. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to the Shock Factor. You know, I want to thank you guys for tuning in. We really appreciate you. 100%. You know, we really appreciate all our listeners in 150 countries around the world.
Yes.
As well. Mike is in the building.
Mike.
Hello, Mr. Shock.
Right. I'm your host, Shock Kim.
I'm Chef Momo.
And everybody else has vacated, right. But we do have these beautiful people.
Right. Oh, Chef Momo, you. Classic beauty, by the way.
Oh, thank you.
Let me put the camera on them.
Okay.
Please don't.
Spotlight.
Oh, right. Yes, sir. Here we go.
Point the camera that way, please. Yeah. Right. Okay. Here it is.
Guys,
those are pretty people.
Tell our audience what's your name and where you're from.
My name is D'Angelo Jackson, and I'm from Los Angeles, California.
Los Angeles, California.
All right. D'Angelo. Yes.
Let's give it up.
Love that name.
Yes. Yes. All right, DJ. Yes.
I want some of your yes, sugar. Yes,
sir. I'm going to show my belly.
Okay.
Don't show your belly. Not yet. Give us a couple of minutes before. And who is the lovely lady that's beside you?
I am Misha, and I'm right by the side of you.
Say your name again.
Misha.
Oh, I thought you said Ebony Misha.
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 With them. I love that.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Nice.
I'm in the house.
The blacker the berry, the sweeter the juice.
Oh, there it is. Right. There it is.
Yeah.
Listen.
Other than.
Take a shot. We know that.
Thank you. Thank you.
Oh, darky over there.
Right.
It doesn't apply to equals.
I was trying to everything. You know, I was trying to everything. So, no, you didn't.
I'm sorry.
No, you
didn't.
Right.
I didn't mean to call him darky.
He did.
I got caught up in my own.
Shot. You know where he's from? Shot? He's from the Motisa tribe.
Give us free. She over there milk dud shade. You know what I'm saying?
Oh, man.
I love you, Cody. That's a cool bro. He's really laid it down for... You know, I've been a cool producer here on LA Talk Live and the Shock Factor.
Yeah.
He's kind of like my hero, Shock.
Yeah.
I want to give him a lot of love for his commitment to that. So my brother, you came in here the other day and I heard, from the producer, they said like, look, hey, this guy right here can sing.
Right. Okay.
He can sing.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
He said, okay. Yeah.
And I was like,
that's right. That's right. Me.
And I was like,
that's the one they're talking about.
Right.
It's me.
I'm humble though.
It's me.
Yeah. Right.
How long you been singing? Where you been singing and what you doing a little bit?
I've been singing since I was 3.
Everybody say that. So what was you singing at 3 years old? Let me just ask.
Probably was ABC.
My first song, actually, it's a funny story.
Let me have to cut Mo off.
God,
man, I'm asking this.
Living in the Nickerson Project.
Cut Mo off on fighting.
Living in the Nickerson Project, 89.
That's right.
My mom heard me singing on the toilet. That's the funniest
thing.
So first
she didn't know I can sing.
Number one or number two?
First
off, I remember. Right, wait.
Here's the thing.
If
she heard him singing on the toilet, that's number two.
When they were little kids, when you're around 2, 1, 3, if you have kids, you know. They sit on the toilet.
I don't have kids.
If you've ever
played
a 3-year-old,
I'm solo
by
myself.
I'm going
by
here.
I ain't got kids.
You're trying to get anything.
And you ain't got kids. Yeah. Oh, talk to us like we just.
If you ever played a 3-year-old, you're trying to get anything to get a peek.
Okay, first of all, I raised a child for 9 years old until he got 9, until the woman said he wasn't my kid. Okay, so I don't want to go there, but I had to say something to Mo. I want to bring everybody back in because she really went there and hurt my feelings.
How did I hurt your feelings? Oh, Mo.
My feelings weren't hurt.
More suck it up, you a man. Momo didn't know. Come on, man, look up. I don't want to hear no sympathy. You a grown-ass man.
OG,
man
up.
You started some shit.
Somebody got time
Shaka,
for that.
What's more important is...
Hold on.
You can see.
Hold on.
That part right
we
there.
We don't know if he can
say just wanted a moment. Right.
So, who's one of your favorite artists? You know, because we have people from
Prince and Michael. This tells a lot.
I'm going to be real. I have so many. Okay. But one who has, since I was 11, I don't know, I can't help it. And I know she's everywhere right now. Some female, Beyonce. Okay.
Beyonce, all right,
I think Beyonce
B.
Is a category to shout out to Michael B.
Okay. Yeah, she's a real singer, but no, let's go back further, really. Who is a real singer now? Let's go back further.
Gladys Knight.
Okay.
Ooh.
No argument for me.
I fuck with you on Gladys Knight. Hold on.
Hold on for a minute, guys.
Hold on. I'm gonna need for you to come closer.
Okay. No problem.
Mo.
All right.
Thank you very much.
Mo.
I rocks with Gladys. Right.
Now,
right.
You know Gladys. You know I got a
Mo,
chance.
I fall for you every time you speak. I swear.
I got a chance to speak with Gladys.
Every time he's talking.
One time I was working with artist. She was working
Is
with.
It the
we
waffles?
Was working on. Hold on, guys. Let me turn off Mo right quick.
Right, turn off for a moment.
First of all, I got to tell my story, Mo.
This is a long story short.
No. And I got a chance to speak on her. She's, you know, I was working with this, you know, artist, and she heard her because she was getting ready to work with her too as well. And she said I was doing a great job, you know. And all I grew, you know, when I was growing up, my mom, all she played was Gladys Knight.
Yeah. Right.
So that was all in my paradigm, Gladys Knight, Gladys Knight. When I got a chance to speak with her, wow. I almost had a heart attack. Wow. I swear to God. I almost had a heart attack because not only do I love, you know, okay. when I got into the worst relationship and I broke up from California to Florida, I listened to Gladys Knight all the way there.
By the way, Shock, my mom dated her dentist for years, right? So I met
Gladys I got to talk to your family.
And she's singing me in my house all the time, right?
You got to be freaking kidding me. I will come over there.
And let me tell you something about Gladys Knight. She's gotten prettier every year, right?
Oh, my God.
She wasn't cute to me when I was younger. Now she's like super fine. So anyway, okay. go ahead. I'm sorry.
And I love Gladys.
So back to you and your other inspiration.
Can you sing for real, dude? Let's sing.
Oh yeah, I can sing.
Let's get it then.
Hold on, hold on. Let's get it in. Make sure he's right.
I'm gonna sing one of my song. A piece of my song.
Okay.
It's called Can I?
Can I? Can I?
Can I?
Right. And,
can I?
Love it.
That's a wine they made up.
I'm going to need for you to. There you go.
There it is. All right. Yeah.
Go ahead and get it in. Hold on. Hold on, ladies and gentlemen.
Okay.
Go, right I want here. You to introduce him. Go ahead. You. Go.
Right here, you guys. Let's check it out. We're checking out DJ. Let's check it out. All right.
We're rooting for you, baby. We're rooting for you, baby. We're rooting for you, baby. Come on.
She kind of got stuck there. You don't know me. You don't know me, nigga.
All right.
All right, go.
Let's give it up. Can I stop for a minute? I just want to let you know I did it in the way she was with it. Can I stop for a minute? Can I stop for a minute? I just want to let you know I did it in the way she was with it. Can I stop for a minute? You and I, we had some good times. I'm not trying to change your mind. All the things that we went through, the ups and downs, I was there for you. You put it down when I'm not around, like a child in the playground. All the love that I have for you, don't you know you are still my boo? I'm a little confused. What the hell am I gonna do? You know my heart hurts for you. I cannot breathe if I'm not with you. Can I stop?
I wrote that a long time ago.
All right. What?
Okay. I ain't mad at that, man.
Okay. That sounds good.
Yo.
Oh,
why,
yeah.
Look, why did you stop?
Oh, my God. I hear you.
Okay, I can dig that. Yes. Yes.
Right.
Yes.
So you've been, go ahead.
I need you out of your comfort zone.
Okay, look, I just need.
Too comfortable. I'm sorry. I don't want what you wrote. I need to hear you.
Say something else.
Girl, I'm talking about go all the way
out. Shut up. You said that was beautiful.
What Beyonce, you say you like, I'm not, granted, Beyonce is probably the most prolific female artist ever. Of you know one of the you know when it comes to entertainment,
right?
You know I'm gonna entertain Tina Turner, obviously.
Janet Jackson.
You know well.
Right.
You say Janet, entertainer.
Okay, yeah. Janet. Obviously, she was the bomb.
Let's talk singers, though. Let's talk singers,
right? Right.
But
right.
I'm talking about you know Beyonce. When we're talking about singers, when we talk about Aretha, you know, we're talking about you know some of those you know Patti LaBelle. Mm-hmm. When we talk about you know
Stephanie
so many
Mills.
Yeah, so many. You know, and I love Beyonce. I think today Beyonce is the total
B
artist.
Is the, yeah.
I think she's the total
artist.
She's
one of the best ever did.
She's the stuff.
No, you know, she's the total artist today.
She's the stuff.
You know, when it comes to that, you know, but everything regenerates. So what are you doing right now with your career?
Mm-hmm. You know what?
Let's ask a couple of questions before we get out by
To
here.
Be real, I'm just getting back to it.
Yeah.
Okay.
I went through it.
Tell us about
a
it.
A time right that where right. I didn't want to. Thing no more.
Why? Right.
And
why
that's
was
not
it?
Me.
It happens right. to everybody. Exactly. It happens no. to everybody.
What happened?
It happens
Tell
to everybody.
Us about that.
You know, just a lot going on.
Right.
Haters, this. I mean, I wouldn't say haters, but family members.
Yeah.
And all this
the
other.
The people that
they are
supposed to love you.
Talking your mic.
Yeah. You know what I mean? People that are supposed to be there
the
and love you.
The people that's
you,
close
you know?
To you. Yeah.
And wow. it's just like, dang, do I got it? Can I still go? You know?
Right.
All right.
I'm not a hater. I want you to
put your best foot forward.
That's right.
All right, so
that's why we're here in this kind of environment.
That's right.
That's why we're in this kind of environment, DJ, because, mm-hmm. you know, if those kind of people in life, even if it's family, blood, it's sticking in the water, whatever the case may be,
right.
you know, sometimes in life, and these are just lessons to learn in life, mm-hmm. that you might have to go outside of that so-called that you Word. Thought was love yeah, to go seek
Word.
Your love, you know, and be around your like kind, the people that's going right. to bring that out of you, such as this young lady, Misha. Yeah. Apparently, you. She brings that out of yeah. you. You're with her.
You obviously yeah. got I'm skills. I want to hear you outside oh, yeah. of your comfort zone.
I want to hold on, guys, for a couple of seconds.
You right about that.
You got hold skills.
On.
No
hold
question.
Hold on for a couple of seconds. Okay. Now, yeah, talk about Gladys Knight. And Gladys Knight, one of the most prolific songs that I love the most. I want y'all to hear this, right? This song right here, when she comes
Either
in.
Either one of them.
Yeah. Listen how she comes in. Listen to her.
It's sad to think. Come on now. Bring her. We're not
gonna make it. It came in smooth.
It's emotional.
And it's gotten to the point. So, when we hear this, right?
All right.
You know. Artists, you know, who's doing this today?
Man.
You know, because, like I said,
they took she ain't got to show off right away.
No. Yeah. You feel
yeah,
me?
But you know, but sometimes you gotta go back to the fact that there is the love. You understand? That's when people were really in love with people.
Music.
And people
right,
really
right.
hurting. Like, yes. Gladys was hurting. She's singing about
exactly.
this. I'm telling you, this is my love. What I feel. Yes. And if you can't feel that, it's not going to come across.
No, I'm in love with you right now.
Right.
I swear to God. I swear to God.
You're right.
You just turned.
You're right.
I'm in love with you
she's
right now.
So right now.
Straight
we just got to go back to that. In you order know, to get to, in order to get that.
That's why I called you out. Just like that.
Right.
Look, I can't sing a lick.
Right, but you know, music.
Give it up, baby. Give it
there
up.
There you go.
And our whole thing here in the Shock Factor, and what we want to do, not only the aesthetic part, you know, it's the business part. Mm-hmm. It's the whole, you know, person when they go through this so-called music business.
Right.
We want to talk about those things. We want to talk about and bring up aspects, and we want to get back to the real music.
Mm-hmm. Yeah,
you know what I'm saying? A lot of people are. You know, not really focused on the real music because they want the money.
Yeah. Right.
Want,
exactly. That's right.
You know what I'm saying? They
it's
want
the gratification. Exactly. It's the gratification, you know?
Yeah.
If I was you, what I would do is those experiences that you experienced, those negative experiences of the family members, sing about it.
Yeah. Yeah.
Write about that.
Exactly.
There's
that's
a lot of people that go
that
through that, believe it exactly. or not. And your family yeah. members will be the hardest ones on you. And they will make you want to give up. Because
exactly.
you're thinking in your mind, man, if I'm hearing this from them, from a stranger, I'm
DJ.
Sure
yeah.
that it'll be like that too.
Yeah.
Write songs based off experiences, and it's the best, to me,
it's the best motivation.
Exactly.
Baby, DJ, always know this. Always know this for the rest of your life, and you pass this on to somebody else too once you understand this knowledge. That a prophet is without honor in his own home,
what'd you
and
say,
in his
Ron?
Own hometown.
What'd you say, Ron?
Oh.
What you know what I'm saying?
It's going to take people,
a prophet is without honor in his own home and in his own hometown. It will take people that are far
Hold
away from
now.
You to tell your people that are close to you how dope
that
you
are.
Nah.
And then your people be like, for real?
Like, who, him? Not my neighbor?
DJ?
Because understand this, they did
yes.
Christ, they did Jesus the same way.
You're right.
And let me tell you something, bro.
The son of a carpenter? He's my next door neighbor.
I called you out and start and initiate this whole conversation because I hear the control in your voice.
Exactly.
And yeah. I hear the technique.
You got to let yourself
go. You know what I saw?
Be that butterfly.
I saw you go back to what you're comfortable with on the first song.
Your first song that you wrote.
When I want you to take a chance because this right here, you don't want to record it that you didn't take a chance.
Cause this is recorded, right?
Yeah. Right, so, right.
You don't want
right.
it to be heard that you didn't take a chance mm-hmm. tonight.
Well, not only that, don't you ever let anybody
that's right.
tell you can't do something.
No,
right.
Or make you
Amen.
Feel or make
it's
you
impossible.
Feel that you,
Amen.
Cause you are surrounded by nothing but artists
yeah.
that
no.
we've all
right.
been through that
Amen.
Same thing
yeah.
as well.
Right.
But look, we are now together amongst a like kind.
And this is a comfortable spot right
we're
here.
Amongst a like kind.
Ooh,
you see what I'm saying?
Right here.
Yeah. You know, we speak about Compton and all that earlier. You see what
Can we stop talking with him? Set some shit out, baby.
We are around our own like kind.
Sing your favorite song you ever heard. How about that?
Now, here's the favorite. You know,
don't even get the words right. Don't even get the words right. Sing anything.
Okay.
Go ahead.
I know. I'm sorry.
What you know about this?
Look, first of all,
you know what it is.
Oh,
before
right.
you start,
you can blow this.
Before you
I'm
start,
to think of something.
Let me proclaim
I'm
my love.
I'm playing it right now. You don't know what I'm doing.
Okay,
please.
He's playing.
No, here we go.
You might not even know. Do you know
here
this?
Go.
You don't know this?
always and forever.
Come on, baby, come on.
Moment with you is just like a dream to me that somehow came true.
Come on now.
Gonna get lost.
I know tomorrow.
You ain't here with number artists, so you ain't gotta be acting shy with us.
Still be the same.
The $1 million contract on the line. You in the recording booth.
We've got a life of love that won't ever change.
And let's go.
Every day.
Okay.
Love me your own special.
He in the shower now, y'all. Come on. Come on. He in the shower. He in his bedroom now.
With a smile.
And he's a good looking motherfucker too now. I'm sorry.
Take time to tell me you really care.
That's intonation for all you artists.
If you said tomorrow.
Come on. Together.
I'll always love you. Ever.
Yeah.
All
right. Yeah. There it is, ladies and gentlemen.
Yes. 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 I love it. Yes.
Okay, guys.
I felt that.
I love your energy.
Yes, sir.
So, look, we're going to go ahead and close out the
shot. That's
Shakim
a G right there, by the way. That's yeah. a G. That's G shit right there.
Anybody want to give any shout outs before we go ahead and go?
Y'all give us some shout outs.
Let's start it from this
Mike,
end.
Mike, Mom, you want to give us some
shout outs? And
shout-outs?
Then we're
going to
go.
I'm a shout out to straight up G artistic shit. When a motherfucker asshole like me calls you out, you stand up and fucking show G shit. And I'm cussing
That's
like
right.
I, because
okay,
I'm emotional about it.
I am.
The nigga look good.
I am.
Gotta look, you know what I'm saying? I'm in love with Mo. I'm gonna throw that in too. I'm sitting next to Rock, and it's an artist thing, comfortable place. Real thing.
That's right. That's right.
There it is.
That's
there
right.
It is.
That's right.
That's my brother Mike.
Mike B. All
Mike
Bond.
Right, Mike.
Yo, I'm gonna send some shouts out because I'll leave soon. By the way, we got people watching out there, so we want to give a shout out to Fisk University. It's our homecoming weekend. You know what I'm saying? So,
thank you.
Fisk University. You know what I'm saying? And shout out to my homegirl Amy Jo out there in Pennsylvania. Shout out to my homegirl Jackie Rodriguez out there in Florida. Shout out to my pilot friend, very good friend who'll be at our show coming up at the Fish Fry. My girl
That's
Fontaine
right.
Marcy, hell of a pilot, you know what I mean? So
all right.
Shout out
to
you.
Right. Man,
you know somebody that Amy Jo
what the hell?
Yeah.
You know what
I'm saying? I love you even more now. I like to send this out of Detroit, Michigan. My cousin who was online earlier was on the show with Darlene. Shout out to my man Morris Hayes. That was up in here.
Get it right.
Of course, want to give a shout out to Young Misha right here. My man DJ Does His Blue. Shout out to Chef Mo. Shout out to Shakim, LA Talk Live, Rich and Chef Stevie up in the building.
Once again, I love
my
you.
Boy Mike Bond in the house.
That's
shout
what
out
is.
To my brother B Rock, Shea Boog, my son Okewa,
how about that?
My mama, my sister, and all of Detroit West Side, J
Road,
and Westwood, time, man. Detroit deep.
Shout out Detroit against everybody.
Right.
Everybody.
Everybody.
Detroit, what?
All right. So this is Misha, and I want to say what's up to DJ. DJ got the vocals going.
Came with it.
Tonight. Came with it tonight. That's so right. I want to let him know that he got the shout out.
All right.
And this is for my mom and my dad and my brother. I love y'all. Y'all right. with me. You know,
they're
every
watching.
Time we
She's
out here,
right,
we do it. We do it, do it big.
Do it big.
All right, yeah.
Do it, do it.
So,
and I want to give a shout out to my mom, Desiree, in Compton, east side of Compton, Atlantic.
Compton.
And all of y'all in here.
You're Compton right. nigga, too?
I'm from L.A., but resident
here.
Compton, though.
Represent.
And I
want to
give a shout out to all the haters. All the haters. Thank y'all.
That's right.
Thank you, motherfuckers.
That's right. Thank you.
Below Century is a badge of honor, baby.
Believe it.
What? And the Momo, though.
Oh, man. Oh, thank you. Thank you.
I'm in tears.
I like to thank the good Lord.
All day long.
Right, Mo. Waking me up this morning, clothing my right mind.
Exactly.
Gotta thank God.
Start me on my way.
Wonderful Friday. Thank everybody that came through tonight. All of the guests. Everybody sat here on the panel. Ecor the Wolf.
Yes.
Wonderful host, Shakim, to Life, to Rich, to Stu, to everybody here. Right. Also, I gotta thank Jersey that's tuning in.
Dirty Jersey in the house.
Jersey.
Jersey
in the building's watching.
T-Neck, baby.
Alabama. You can go on Instagram.
Bessemer.
I am Chef Momo on Instagram. Follow me on Twitter, right. Monique Moore, and Facebook, Monique Moore. Shout out to my artist, Emma Renna.
Emma Renna.
Right. Also, you want to party with me this Sunday? I'm gonna be at the Congo Room with one of my homegirls, Vita Guerrero. Is hosting. Vita.
Hold on,
oh, man. What, Sunday?
Ladies and gentlemen?
What?
Hold on for 1 second.
Hold on.
Hold on for 1 second, please.
Rewind.
We gotta rewind that. This Sunday. This Sunday.
I don't even have a freaking ticket.
You won't need a ticket.
Oh, we won't?
You don't need a ticket.
Okay. What about you? He won't need a ticket.
Y'all don't need tickets. So shout out to Stereotype Entertainment. You can go online. If you go on my Instagram, you'll see the flyer. I don't have it with me, but I have it, but I don't feel like pulling it up. But Stereo Entertainment presents Twerk Fest. So you know anybody that's twerking, you can win $1,000 cash prize for twerking.
You twerk more. You twerk more.
Miley Cyrus gonna be there.
Not for $1,000, I won't.
I'm sorry.
Miley Cyrus gonna be there.
You must gotta be broke.
I'm so happy to hear that. I don't know.
Hey Mo. Miley Cyrus gonna be there twerking.
No, she might show up. Who knows? But it's hosted by my very good friend Vita Guerrero. So come out, have a good time.
Oh, she gotta be a twerker. Gotta be a twerk fest. She hosts it.
Yeah. So again, shout out to Emma Renna. Follow my artist Emma Renna Music on Instagram. Shout out to China Mines. We got new music that's coming out too. All We're dropping a single soon.
Dope.
Shout out to Press Play. Shout out to Pablo de Capo.
China Mines.
China
Pablo.
Myers. Yes.
Poppy.
Yes.
Poppy.
My publicist China. Like I said, download my single. I Rock. It's on iTunes.
I Rock.
Don't get back.
Yeah. It's going down.
Hey, Shot. Homie call. Mo, can you say my name just one time, please?
Ah.
Mike.
Thank you.
Mike! Nigga, you ate this shit.
Tell him Mike on the mic. Y'all taking over Shakim, sure.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying?
Okay.
I'd really have control. Right. You want to see?
Show him. Say something. Say.
Okay, ladies and gentlemen, I want to thank everybody for tuning in to the Shock Factor. Everybody shut up, man. I'm going to put y'all back on and shit. I love y'all energy, though.
Right,
you know what I'm saying?
Right.
You got us to check her.
No, no. Sometimes you just get a little bit overbearing.
The energy is great.
But I want to thank Chef Mo.
That's right,
once
Chef
again.
Mo.
Thank Chef you. Mo, you are the bomb.
Oh, yeah.
The
you
bomb.
Are the bomb.com,
She brought in some bomb-ass food tonight.
All day. I want to thank, hey, my
yes,
man.
Oh, yeah, Chef Mo.
Your vocals were good. You know what I'm saying? We got to get you back in here.
Okay.
We're going to hear some.
We might want to put him on. We might want to put him on the Wolf's Den. You know, first Friday of every month.
I want you to get in contact with Wolf.
Okay.
Get you on the Wolf's Den. You know, we do it every once every month.
Right. Mm-hmm. First Fridays.
That's what I'm talking about.
You know, yeah, and I love your energy.
Thank you. I'm here.
And yes,
I'm a supporter.
Well, you know, that's what I do. And we love your color too. Hey, Wolf.
Yes, sir.
Once again, another week has passed us by, and you've done another great job. You
Thank
brought
you
Darlene,
much.
And you know the artists that you bring in here. We really appreciate you.
Yes. Thank you.
Yes.
Very
yes.
much,
let
brother.
You know how we
oh,
feel
yeah.
about you.
Thank you very
oh,
much.
And
yeah.
She was awesome.
No yeah. substitute yes. for hunger. No substitute for hunger.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah. She was awesome. Want to give it up to Darlene. Want to give it up once again for Mo.
Oh, yeah.
She brought in my.
Mo.
You know, come on, Mo.
Morris Hayes.
I got your musicians up in here.
Come on, Mo.
Shout out to Mo.
Give it up for Mo.
For that.
For bringing in Morris Hayes.
Not Dave.
Right.
Hey, ladies and gentlemen, I know I may have said Morris Day, but we talked about bringing in Morris Day in before.
No, not with me.
Yes, we did.
I don't know Morris Day.
You know his man? I thought you knew his manager.
No, I know Jimmy Jam and all the.
No, we talked about it. We're going to talk about that.
Anyway.
I have to cut everybody off because nobody's agreeing with me. So I'm going to get everybody back on. Hey, Mike. I want to thank you, my brother, for coming in, fucking with your boy as well.
I love your grace, by the way. Oh, Mike off. There we go.
We're getting ready to get out of here. Richie Rich.
Hey, fuckers. You better go.
What is it?
We're getting kicked out.
What is it? We got to clean the garbage.
Get him out of here.
You got to go.
You're my nigga up there.
Yes, we got to go.
I want to thank Life MC.
Crazy.
Life, sir.
Everybody for tuning in.
The lights has been cut off.
And we got to get out of here.
The general maintenance just got to
do something. I don't know. So, ladies
that's
and gentlemen,
right.
Mo, that's
once again,
for a slow dance, bro.
All right.
It's getting freaky in here tonight. So
like,
look,
you fine?
Hey.
Oh, like what happened?
Hey, Shakim, we like a little bit into LAX After Dark right now. Just a little tad bit
just
into it.
Just a little bit of LAX
into
After Dark.
Right.
What happened?
But we're going to go ahead and close down the Shock Factor. And I want to thank everybody for tuning in once again to another Friday. We do this every Friday at 8 o'clock Pacific Standard Time, all the time, every day, all day. Yes. Music, music business. We also love to talk about conspiracies. We love to talk about just life in general. Life. And everything that we can do to help you inspire yourself to be a better person.
On the Shock.
You know what I'm saying? So once again, thank you for tuning in. We love you. Thank everybody you. That's out there in Atlanta. Everybody that's out there in Cleveland. Yes. Everybody that's out here in LA. We love you once again. Everybody that's overseas in 150 countries that's listening to you, listening to us. We want to thank you
thank
for tuning
you for
in.
Listening. We know you had a choice.
We're having a color today.
Yes.
We know
yes.
that you have a choice in internet radio, and we gladly and appreciate that you have chosen taking the time out for LA Talk Live and the Shock Factor Show.
So, yes. ladies and gentlemen, look. Go out there tomorrow or tonight or whenever and just do something for somebody other than yourself.
All right.
You know what I'm saying?
Pay it forward. It's called love.
Sounds good.
Go do something for somebody positive.
That's right.
You know what I'm saying? Thank you, Mo.
Keep the peace.
We love you. We see you next week. Same time, same sandbox. 8 o'clock Pacific Standard Time. I'm your host, Shakim Williams.
Chef Momo.
Equal the Wolf.
And we got my man Mike and my two talented friends,
Misha and DJ.
Misha and DJ.
Thank you guys.
Thank you.
We'll see you next week, guys.
Yes, sir. Keep it going.
November 24th, Fish Fry at the Mint.
We know there are many choices in internet radio, and the staff and host of LA Talk Live would like to thank you for choosing the internet's hottest destination for the most eclectic sound and invigorating talk. This is LA Talk Live. We are more than just talk. Oh, how could you be so heartless? Talking, talking, talking.